This episode of the Esoteric Order of Roleplayers is brought to you by the generosity of our backers on Patreon. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+, and visit our Patreon page at patreon.com/esotericrp to find out how you can become a backer too. The Esoteric Order of Roleplayers present Prophecies of Doom, a RuneQuest Glorantha campaign, with David Larkins as the Game Master.
He's no big deal.
All right, so here we are.
What was the thing? Something, 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 or Gosmo?
Oh my, well, see, now I'm going to have to cut this out.
Why? So. We consider Gosmo.
That's a great intro. Something, something, something.
Or Gosmo.
Or Gosmo. All right, fine. So,
we're starting now.
I think you two are very cute, by the way. Can I say that?
Oh,
without you
cutting
my
mouth?
Yeah,
that's
true.
It's true.
Don't cut it out. That's true. Just the hearts. They're just. Oh.
Wait, I think I put it up.
Yeah.
By the way, it's stimulado, stimulado,
stimulado,
orgasmo. All right, so.
I like that you shit talked it for a second, but you knew exactly.
I know. He does that to me all the time.
I went it's right like, back to the giant.
It's back to I heard about that.
Big club.
Big club.
Why do you look at me?
You're crustable. No, and so actually, that was the thing, a point of resolution I never got. Was that, so like, did you guys, like, was, did he kill him? Did you fight him? Did you, like, sweet talk?
Oh, wait. You had something in your beard.
Oh, thank you.
A giant?
Yeah, because I heard all the talk of, like, you know, like, well, he's nude coming out of his bath, you know, but
yeah.
I never got the, like,
oh, no, the giant fell for her. Thank
you.
The giant fell for her, and so she sweet talked him.
In the cavern?
She sweet talked him into breaking his oath. To kill a bunch of brew.
It's worse. So
no, it's great.
Eli decides to rumble Earth speak talk to him in a way that I can't understand because I don't speak that. And promises me to him without consulting me in any way.
I mean, he's a slave. I think he's, the qualms are there.
Mm-hmm.
You're still a free person if you're an agency.
Yeah.
You're just married.
And then he insisted that his way of helping was that instead of sending us down the path where he moves a boulder over the opening so that you starve to death, he showed us the correct direction to go.
It's a very passive-aggressive way to kill someone.
Yeah.
He thought it was his favorite joke.
It was a joke.
Yeah. It's a prank. It's a prank. So.
Prank is you die.
Yeah, that's the prank.
Yeah.
So he showed us the correct path, and we got there, and there's like a million. And David was like, so I'm not saying you have to do this, but just as a thought, you could try to go talk the giant into coming with you again.
Because otherwise you may die.
So I was like, but if he tells you that, I think that's what you should do. So I think
the line was, we haven't even gotten to the man scorpions yet, so.
Yeah, man scorpions.
You missed man scorpions.
Yeah, they're basically like centaurs except scorpion bodies instead of horses.
Like the rock
in the mummy.
Yeah.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. But of course,
Jade and I clearly need to have a mummy marathon.
Yeah,
Oh yes, I'd be down for that.
So Big Club, but Big Club was sad the last time we saw him. He gave a meaningful, no, giants aren't meaningful, but he looked upset. He had tears in his eyes, and he was killing all of his human friends in his cave.
Brew friends.
But then later it was established that they're not actually his friends, and he does actually hate them. It's just that he had promised not to kill them.
Yeah, he takes his oath seriously.
So he's not that upset that they're dead. He's just upset that he had to violate
break a promise.
It for me.
Mm.
I mean, of all things to violate for
I
you.
Feel horrible about it, so...
It's a complicated start to your relationship.
But I don't think we talked about the most important element with the micropenis.
No, it's not!
We did talk about that. That was actually what we talked
for
about.
Comma.
For a good
the most
third
of,
the lunch, yeah.
It was discussed at most length.
Yeah.
It's not in my... Oh, so you missed basically a 20-minute conversation about us trying to figure out the ratios.
No, we had a 20-minute conversation about you guys having a 20-minute conversation.
How could we have continued in the game, though? until we had that.
I agree.
I know, it's important.
I agree with that. I just think with the clarity, it's also important to clarify that it's not a micro penis for Kaba. That's a big deal.
So we get that. Kaba is a large lady with large needs.
That's pretty large. And then David tells me, I'm not sure if you can reproduce with them without it killing you when you give birth. And so I was like, yeah,
I mean, the head might be too big, yeah.
I'm not as sure that I'm okay with dying just to give birth in the game or in life.
True.
It's not a path.
I don't know. I think it'd be the shoulders more.
Yeah, the shoulders.
Oh, yeah.
The head could be squishy. It's like a cat. If the shoulders can't get through, the rest of it's not coming out.
Then you die.
Then you die.
You raided the treasure room on the way out. Mm-hmm. You also got treasure, which I have written down.
Yeah. You got treasure. Well, I really didn't get that much treasure, which I'm disappointed by. But I free prostitutes and healing at any temple of Shalana Aroy, so.
Yeah.
Which I think is pretty good.
It's a perk.
It is a perk, but I want to buy my freedom.
Yep. Alright, so.
I'm going to have to buy it with money.
Did you
hear? What am I gonna do?
Your loyalty and affection as a friend.
I know. It's gross.
Well, I tried to sell my other friend. So I don't know if I'm very good with friends.
No. Selling my friend is totally fine. Did you hear that your llama saved the day?
Stampy. Mr. Stampy.
Stampy was amazing.
I know. Saved my ass.
Thank you. And then you healed my ass up on top of the mountain.
Yeah.
Like 20 points of damage?
Like a lot. I think it was like 60.
Yeah.
It was a lot.
Right in the eyes.
You've had not enough charisma. Let me fix this for you.
Let's get that current scars. Hold on.
But I like scars. You actually heal my existent scars. And I'm like, no.
Yeah, right.
You're like less than a badass.
Yeah.
I did that for free.
You're pretty now. No. I mean, no. I just start like that.
Yeah, so, but now, I mean, I think we're further from that, from when that happened.
Yes, right? Yes. Well, as the system mandates, time passes. Interesting bit of game lore that I heard on some podcast, which is that the reason this has so much Pendragon DNA in it is because basically Pendragon was created by Greg Stafford after he was stymied in putting those mechanics into the third edition of RuneQuest.
Mm.
Because RuneQuest had kind of been sold to a different company, so they had some say in it.
Wow.
And he's like, hey, I want to put in this stuff about like passions and winter phases and you know, all the other stuff that's in here. And they're like,
yeah.
So he's like, fine, I'll make a game about King Arthur instead. So,
wow. Jousting Night on our bottle of wine. Just
yay!
Oh, nice.
Take a picture of it.
Very appropriate.
Oh, yeah. You should Instagram.
I should.
Yeah. Before we devour all of them.
Let me take a picture.
All right, so while Desiree is Instagramming, you guys can start rolling your checks.
Oh, right.
Right.
Wait, what was the... I forgot to do this again, but I remember what I used. Anything you use in combat when you're fighting in combat gets a check, no matter what number it has.
Yeah.
Okay.
Technically, I think it's actually you still need a special success, but that's my little house rule.
Okay.
And then, of course, anything else that got a special success.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Nope, nothing.
You had nothing
I
to...
one.
I don't think so.
Yeah, there wasn't a whole lot of rolling that first session.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, but of course you do get to choose four.
Well, mostly, not just in terms of rolling, just because I'm doing a special.
That too.
Right.
But you do get to choose four occupational or cult skills that you can check and roll against.
And you want to roll under?
Oh!
You're going to roll over and you're going to add your category modifier to the roll.
Okay.
Yeah. Wait, we're trying to get over the number or under the number?
Over.
Okay.
The easiest way to remember it is just think the better you get at something, the harder it is to improve.
Okay.
Right?
Makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Oh, there you go.
And then
that's a 100.
Hey,
okay.
And you just add you add one to your skill.
No.
A D6.
Don't do that.
It's already started.
Call Cthulhu.
It already started.
It has begun.
I can't believe you're backsliding.
Dude, I always am.
Oh my god, I beat it by 10.
I had one.
Spirit
one
up our
one.
Woohoo.
Well, and you choose four, remember.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this eraser is not the right choice for this.
That was a bad choice.
Tell you.
What am I doing? I don't know what I'm doing.
My spirit combat at 90 did not go up anymore.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Shocked.
Yeah.
Shocked,
yeah.
I said it again. Shocked and appalled.
Tend to happen.
Ooh. I'm deeply upset by this.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. My javelin is now 66.
Ooh.
Let's see. Oh, good. Or we can take an average of 3. Is that?
Two.
Two. Fuck you too, I'm slightly more intimidating now than I was.
Ooh.
Oh no, it is an average of 3. I was thinking of training. Training is 2.
Well, I was thinking if it's an average, it would have to be.
Yeah, you're quite right. That's why I thought to check. Okay.
I like it that you're saying okay, like somehow we'd be done. I'm not anywhere close to them.
Oh my god.
Oh god, really?
Oh yeah!
I had a lot of fighting awesome. That went.
Yes,
on.
You did.
True. Yeah.
Plus, you got to pick the 4 things, right?
Right.
And that's including runes or not including runes.
That is only occupational or occult skills.
Right. Okay.
Does anyone want to do any training or research?
I probably do.
Yeah.
And just as a reminder, training costs money. Research is free. Or you can, if anyone's been working on increasing a characteristic, I don't know.
Mm. Oh, I want Eli to train, well, maybe. I was gonna say I want Eli to keep training me to be more intimidating, but I don't know, after selling me out to fucking goofball
yeah,
face.
You do what you need to do to survive.
And that's intimidating.
Yep.
Willingness to sell out your friends.
That does
yeah. Maybe to train my meditation?
Could that be meditation is that what?
Wary about.
25. I want you to teach me Earth speak
oh,
so that never happens
yeah.
to me.
No wonder you kept failing.
Yeah.
That would be 30 lunars.
Okay.
You're good for that?
Yes.
Okay.
Rune affinities?
After that windfall.
Can you train rune affinities?
Yeah.
Yes, you can.
Okay.
So, for training, you can roll 1d6 minus 1 or just take a flat 2% increase.
2%. That's a lot of mathing there.
That's a lot of
math. No, just plus 2.
Oh, okay. I'll try the D6. Here we go. Boom.
There you go. 5.
5? Okay. That's great. Meditation's up to 30 now.
So you can do runes.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks, Dad. I'm thrilled.
Okay, so if my skill is 30.
All right, 30. And let's see here. What is the rune?
Water.
Okay, so
how do we train? You just pick something, I guess?
You just pick what you want to do. And then if sometimes you can't if they're too high.
Oh,
but I'll let
they
you
have
know.
To be over 60, right? Or under 60.
No, I think it's
75,
80.
75, actually. 75, yeah.
They have to be under 75.
Yes.
So that sucks. All right.
Yeah, that's like pretty much.
That does suck because everything I want to train is,
yeah.
However, you can try and work on your, oh no, even research is limited to 75 or under. Yes. All right.
Yeah, you gotta use it or lose it.
Once you get a certain level of good at something, then you can only get better by actually practicing.
Mm-hmm. Let's see here. Mm-hmm. An instructor must normally be paid in some fashion.
All right, I get to
pick 4. Cost training. Current value of the skill. Okay. I think. Okay. We're just gonna go with what is your rune value at? Jane? It's a 3-0.
Looks like.
Sounds like.
Thank you. Two cool. syllables. Is that a rune that's affiliated with your god?
No, a god.
It is not.
I don't think so.
God.
No, it's not.
All right. Well, in that case, it would be 100 lunars.
No.
No. Well, it's just, you know.
Wait, but you got money, I think. In the
oh, yeah.
In the cave or whatever.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
What did she get?
No. Yeah, she got a hell of a lot of money, actually. She got, I think, I thought it was a, no. I was thinking
who
had chest.
That was me.
Yeah, that was that was me.
Jesus, maybe we didn't write down something for Puik.
I mean, I know Puik got stuff, but I forget what.
Because I have stuff for... Hend went and got that idiot birdcage from the crack in the wall.
Yeah, with the white bird in it.
The white mouse, actually.
The white mouse? Oh,
yeah.
I thought it was a bird.
Ah, that's a mouse.
Is it an enchanted mouse or is it just a mouse?
Who knows?
Oh, wait. No. Pweek wasn't inside with us because she was rounding up the horses.
You're right.
Because she wanted to keep her out of the potential fight. So she was out having the fire.
But my suggestion was just to get lost in the caves.
I know. But if it makes you feel any better... what you didn't know is that there was a clan of cannibal ogres in the caves. So maybe not.
Yeah. They ran away when they saw us, though.
Yes, they did.
They had pretty high charisma. I could have talked them out of it.
But if it makes you feel any better, Hen isn't keeping the bird cage. He just took it to go make nice with Gringle as a trade.
It's true.
Oh. You know, like, sorry about the tooth getting stolen. Here's a cage.
Also, sorry we fucked up your house, you
yeah.
mean?
Yeah,
well, letting a bunch of...
Yeah, the cage is worth like 80,000 lunars, so, yeah.
What's the mouse worth?
Mouse comes free with the cage.
And what if it's a... If it's a rune that's affiliated with my god...
Uh-huh. Oh,
I was just curious, like, what's
in that case, if it was... Well, it depends on the level.
Gotcha.
But if it was at the same... If it was a 30, let's just say, it would have been 60 lunars.
Oh, okay. I'm just trying to get, like, a sense of scale.
Yep.
But it's, that sounds like that's about the scale for most of the other...
Well, common... If it's a common skill, then it runs from 10 to 40... If it's a professional skill or a rune associated with your Ooh. God, it runs from 30 to 250.
I know.
And then rare, obviously, is about double that.
I get training in Orlenthi area.
Of course.
My skill is currently at 0, which means I'm kind of, you're like, roll area lore. I'm like, nope.
Nope. Yeah, sure.
Imagining, though, by this point, I've learned at least, hopefully, a little bit about Orleans.
Yeah. I would think so.
Maybe.
So that will just be 10 lunars.
Okay. Let's see if that's a little bit nicer.
How many things can we train in? As many as we want?
Nope, just the one.
No.
All right, and then D6 or flat 2?
D6 minus 1 or D6 flat 2. Okay. So if you roll a 1, you have 0.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I got a 1.
Oh, no!
What?
Well,
no!
It's just not sticking.
It was only
sticking.
10 lunars.
It's not sticking, you know?
I wasn't impressed the last time. I was like, really? You guys just let chaos creatures like have a whole valley to themselves?
That shit would not stand in Prax.
It's really good. Actually, it's pretty gross.
Can
like,
I go to read and write?
What is it?
Yes.
Kava is tired of being
it's like a research.
The Department of Literacy.
That we hate chaos.
Okay, so 10 lunars for that.
That's it? Mm-hmm. And so what do I roll? The
D6 minus 1 or plus 2?
Gross. Aren't you like super into
I got
chaos?
A 6.
Good.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm no more longer a moron.
No, I'm not.
Oh, no, it's
I'm super into death and earth.
Is it A?
Me too.
Is it what?
Is it across the board, or do I have to pick one language?
You have to pick one language. So Sartorite would be the most logical one.
Portling? I thought that was our language.
Yeah, but the text is called Sartorite.
Oh, okay. Same thing, though.
Yeah.
You're learning how to read and write?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because she's tired of being, like, and we walked into the cave and all of us were like, only one person can read this. What does it say? She's like, I want to at least know some things.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
I know you all think I'm just this giant moron tank, okay, but...
That's not true. Your intelligence is very high, so...
Yeah, I know. That's why she's embarrassed that she has pretty high intelligence and cannot read or write literally at all.
Well, intelligence covers more than just, like, you know, scholarly pursuits.
And in fact, most people can't read or write.
Yeah. Well, now I feel even better. Because I can now.
I just love that Eli's like, no, we also look for your mind.
10 points of learning.
Trying to make it up to her.
Also, you all get a plus 1d3 to your reputation, so you can roll that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got a 3.
Me too.
Nice.
I have a whopping 19 now.
Did you say you're a whopping 19?
A whopping. Whopping. Not a octopus. A octopus 19.
They're in my mind.
This would be a 3, right? This head on your belt.
That is a 3.
I got rid of it when
I know you did. But,
was still
just like,
but you know what? She had this sign that she was about to throw into the fire where she was like, I could just keep tearing its body off over and over again for the next like several hours just to fuck with it.
That's
but we had shit to do. If we'd been walking home, she totally would have just been like, Rick.
Like like a fruit.
Of course, she wouldn't have known that they grow new ones, right? So I would have been
right.
Making,
you would have been making new ones.
Watermelon.
Oh my gosh, that's right.
Yeah, not
just
good.
Creating a trail of like vengeful, resentful.
Yes. Oh, that would have been sweet. And add one for Kava because of your whole thing with Big Club.
To my rep.
Yeah.
I'm at 20%.
What?
Boom!
Now everybody knows.
One fifth of a person
and
knows
go,
me.
How could that woman fuck a guy with a micro penis?
Oh my god, we get to have sex and he's not a micro penis for me!
But you know, as the story gets around, it's just, you know,
right,
yeah.
One of you says
one
roll
person
for rumor,
say it.
And
yep,
then that's gonna be one of the rumors is like, Kava fucks giants.
Yeah.
What? I have not
that's
even
pretty
fucked
badass.
One
they
giant.
They have to know that it's a micro penis.
See, yeah.
See, that's right.
Carrying over from our velvet glove exchange.
Yes, that's true.
Eli, what are you doing to me? Stop spreading rumors about dicks and giants and eggplants and no, what was it, a squash?
Butternut squash.
Yeah, baby butternut squash.
A little one.
Baby nut squash. That's my pet name for him, in fact, is baby nut
baby
squash.
Baby nut squash.
Oh! If we ever meet again.
You will.
Baby nut, how you doing?
Oh my god. When it shows up on your doorstep with, like, I don't know, a small tree.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Aww. Just a birch.
I picked this for you.
A little sapling.
Alright, well, speaking of rolling for rumors, why don't we just do that one more time?
Yeah,
one last time.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Wait, what do we roll?
Percentile.
Me.
I got a 99.
Oh.
Nice.
Jesus.
Renee, how did you do?
47.
Oh, I got 46.
Whoa!
Okay. 47 is the daughter of the Red Emperor, is a demigoddess incarnation of the Red Goddess.
Oh,
that's
Loruma. What's the Red Goddess?
The moon.
Oh, that's right. That whole thing. That chick.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And then, Jade, you got a 90 what?
99. Glad I rolled it now.
Members of a draconic secret society at the Johnstown Library.
What?
Hold on.
What? Members of what?
A draconic secret society.
Dragon secret society.
Draconic secret society at the Johnstown Library have learned how to use the dragon newt roads and use them to travel to other Lancor Mai libraries, especially the one in the rubble of Old Pavis.
What?
She dropped her pencil. What?
Okay. I may not understand Orlanthe super well, but I definitely understand.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The Dragon Newt roads are these ancient roads that people can't normally walk on, except if you're the Dragon Newt. Okay. And then 46.
Because like they'll kill you, or because like you'll burst into flames, or.
Yes.
Thank you.
Sure,
I'm
okay. 46. The Crimson Bat, the dread chaos demon of the Lunar Empire, feeds on living humans every week.
Wait a minute. Okay, wait a minute.
That's so vampire. It's perfect.
I know. Why did I get that one? Every week. Wait a minute. So I... Oh, it's just lunar demons that attacked me. But I think I saw the Crimson Bat, and I think it made me go crazy.
That was somebody... But I didn't think that was one of us. I thought that was just the thing about the Crimson Bat is that if you see it, you go crazy.
I think somebody in my lineage saw it, or I saw it.
Oh, like one of your ancestors?
Yeah, or me. Anyway, lunar demons attack me. I just want to say that every session.
Also, I was just joking about the roads. They're just invisible, and nobody knows how to get on them except for dragon newts. And once you're on it, you're also invisible. So dragon newts are, you know, presumably
that
moving
is a
along
very
these roads.
Constantly just
know.
Walking around.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That is a cool thing to know. Mm-hmm. All right, and Sage, what'd you roll?
I got a 10 and a 0, which is still just a 10, right?
That would be a 10. Yes.
Doesn't bump it up to
a 0. 0, 0, 0 would be 100.
Mm-hmm. No, but I mean, the 0 doesn't bump it up to like a 20.
No.
Could be I've been doing it this whole time. I've never asked about that. So.
This might be one of
doesn't
those
hurt
ones.
To ask.
There is no 10, roll again.
Yeah,
the rumor is there's no such thing as 10. It's a conspiracy.
Yeah, re-roll that one. That's one of those ones that's outdated by the passage of time.
All right.
59.
Do you want me to roll again?
Yep, gotta roll again.
Are you
sorry.
Serious?
Remember what I said about my dice?
I know.
Although, to be fair, I had good rolls on the upkeep, so.
Mm-hmm.
94 do anything for you?
Ooh, I like a good 94. Let's see. Yeah, you're gonna have to roll that again.
No way! This is dumb.
I'm using outdated material.
It went off. Maybe that'll help.
The dice are even sicker, but they're like, fuck this.
58?
No.
Nope, roll that again.
Oh my Jesus, God.
Why don't I just pick a number?
Yeah, seriously.
Well, it might tell you to pick again.
92.
All right. 92. Ah, there we go. That's good.
Good.
Dragon powers. Dragon powers. That's all one word. All one word. What? Dragon powers are rising again. Doomed.
Uh-oh.
Doomed are those who make twice the same mistakes.
So don't be mean to dragons.
Wait. So instead of a rumor, mine's a goddamn fortune cookie?
Pretty much.
What the fuck? Why do I always get the cryptic shit? Kava's not able to deal with this. And it's about dragons.
Just add in bed to the end. You'll be fine.
Read it again.
Oh, yeah.
Wait a minute. Doomed are those who make twice the same mistakes. In bed.
All right, what was the mistake that was made?
I feel instantly more relieved.
Me too.
Oh, I'm at ease.
What was the big thing they fucked up when the big dragon fight happened? I was at that battle, so it would make sense for me to know.
Oh, yeah.
Sage doesn't remember what it is.
It's pretty cryptic, actually, because there wasn't any mistake made at that battle. It was
Wasn't there a thing where they suddenly started flying around like crazy because somebody fucked something up during the attack or something?
There were some lunar assassins.
That's totally what I want my soundtrack to be.
Came around the back, but
I think that's what it was.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah. Okay. I actually got a little sneak peek at the scenario pack that's going to come out with the new edition, and I was like, oh, everything's current. Oh, all the mechanics are for this edition. Oh my god. having a moment.
Oh.
So anyway.
My god.
Yeah.
All right. It's okay. Come on.
Thanks.
Great. Welcome.
Yeah. Apparently, the sign that you're a real hardcore Glorantophile is at the beginning of if you sit down to play a game set in Glorantha, your first question is, what year is it?
Oh.
You know, because the chronology is so precise.
Yeah.
But,
it's weird.
But yeah, somebody was talking about Craig Stafford running a RuneQuest game, and like 5 out of 6 people were all like, you know, hardcore RuneQuest players, and they're like, what year is it? He's like, I don't know. He's like, what year do you want it to be?
I love it. He's just facilitating.
That's right.
What do you guys want to do?
Mm-hmm.
I'll make it happen.
Basically.
That's a good GM.
Fun facilitating.
Yes.
All right. So, it is sacred time.
What year is it?
The year is 1625. And,
Shit, I thought it was 24.
No!
This changes everything.
Specifically,
it is the end of the year 1625. Mm. Sacred time falls on the equinox. So it is the end of the winter and the beginning of a new year. It is a time for the world to ritually and actually reenact the death and rebirth of the cosmos to replenish the world. For incorporating the entropy of chaos into the world is part of the Great Compromise. Yes, what? Go ahead.
Do we get our magic points back?
Yes, you're
okay,
all
okay,
back.
Okay. Alright, okay, thank you.
Magic points, yes. Rune points, no.
Since there has been a pause.
Yes.
All the shit that we did during Beat Devil Day, did that garner anything in particular for Kappa in terms of, points of the cult or anything, I would think? Or is it just, questional satisfaction?
Yes. Do you want to move up in the cult?
Yes.
Wow. Vicious.
I know, that's a lot of responsibility.
I want to kill every chaos creature ever.
Mm-hmm.
Don't blame you.
So legit.
Yeah.
And I want to learn how to... Oh, that was the thing I was going to train, was how to smash them and make them be dead. I forgot. That was the thing I'm supposed to learn.
There's a special weapon that actually does kill them.
Mm-hmm. Oh, maybe there could be. What is it? You have to learn, banish some kind of bullshit or something?
For what?
To get rid of chaos.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe that can be my reward. Maybe the temple teaches me how to actually banish them so that I'm not growing.
That's a good...
A million goddamn octopus.
Could use your pots.
Okay, so if you want to become an... You are already a lay member of the Cult of Stormbolt. Mm-hmm. So if you want to become an initiate... It's a serious step.
Mm-hmm. That is
serious. Individuals thereby pledge themselves to the focus of a single divine entity. Mm. Unlike lay members who have free association with other cults, initiates may partake only of rituals in their own cult and its associated friendly cults. Pledges are serious, and anyone who would deny their deity is subject to reprisal from the appropriate spirit of reprisal. That's capitalized.
That's double secret probation.
Yep. Discussed in each cult section on leaving the cult. Oh, well. Oh. All right, so to become an initiate, the adventurer must already be a lay member. Check. Mm-hmm. Must have at least one rune with a rating of 50% or more with the god associated with the god. Check. Okay. A candidate for an initiation who is unfamiliar to the temple hierarchy must pass a test, the object of which is to discover the candidate's suitability, sincerity, knowledge, reputation, and personality. This test is abstracted to the following. Donate 20 lunars to the temple. Understand the requirements and obligations asked of an initiate. Improve knowledge of the cult's specialty skills and favored passions. The player of the applicant must roll D100 for each of these pertinent cult skills and favored passions and succeed in at least three of those rolls.
Can I instead just learn how to banish fucking asshole chaos creatures?
Hey man, no, this sounds you know great. What?
Go big or go home.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I'm an initiate to my cult.
No, you're even higher. You are a
Oh, mine says initiate still.
You are a god talker.
I'm a god talker, first of all. Second of all, I'm taking my cult seriously, and I advise you to do the same.
Thanks, Eli.
I'm inspired.
Man who would sell me to giants, I'll take that under advice.
I'm just mansplaining.
Eli's been handing out the Glorantin equivalent of chick tracks to you. So.
I'm just mansplaining.
You're just third gender splaining.
Yeah, I'm just third gender splaining.
Are you manspreading while you're mansplaining?
No.
Oh, okay. Well,
yeah, you wouldn't really have to manspread, honestly.
I don't have to manspread.
There's nothing
either.
To manspread. Oh,
there's no balls in the way.
Yes. It also requires you to sacrifice a point of pow.
Sounds very like
to
you
know, the deity.
It is.
And what will this win me to become an initiate? Like, what's the benefit?
Well, you get an additional rune point.
Yay!
One.
So you would have 4 instead of 3. And then, let's see. You gain access to all common rune spells known to the cult, and chooses one cult special rune spell, so then you would learn your banish spell, for example. So yes, you would learn that spell.
We have to do this.
I know. I'm
so
seriously.
If I'm learning Melissa, you're an initiate.
Yeah. I'm a god talker.
Yeah.
If that's what it takes to learn how to banish, then that's what I gotta do.
Whatever it takes.
Oh my god.
All right, so.
Even better. But we can do this at some later point.
If you want to, during the downtime here, before we get into the thing, if you want to become an initiate.
Your downtime song?
Yeah.
Well, apparently.
All right, let me get another.
I don't have a D100 though. What's the headway?
Oh, well, percentile.
Oh.
Yeah.
Right, that's a thing.
Ratio.
Because I was like, what's a D100? I don't have.
I mean, I do have an actual D100 if you want. Yeah,
that's what I was thinking.
No.
Wait for it.
No.
It has its pouch. Own bag.
Yep.
Yeah. I love it.
Earned
Des, do you not appreciate the D100?
I just find them annoying.
Why? Oh. Yeah. How could you find it annoying with how cool it is?
It looks cool, but what
does it roll like shit, though?
No.
Yes, it does.
Kind of.
It's a little bit hard to determine, like, okay, so with
so also, that would be a 64.
It rolls a lot, though. Like,
yes, it does. It's basically like rolling a sphere. That would be a 71.
It's a golf ball, basically.
That would be a 48, 48? I'd say. Yeah.
I mean, why not roll the giant shiny ball? Like, okay.
Sure. So these are the skills and or passions. Remember, you need to succeed at 3.
Okay.
So favorite passions are devotion, storm bowl, and hate chaos. So you can roll. Mm. You can choose to roll against either both, or none of those.
So I need to have that passion, or I just need
no.
To
these are just things
passion.
You can choose to roll against.
Okay.
So devotion, storm bowl, hate chaos. Okay. And then for your skills, battle, cult lore, storm bull, any of your cultural weapons, ride, scan, sense chaos, track.
Is that Edie?
Yeah.
She burped?
She burped, yeah.
Oh.
Track, understand herd beast, or worship storm bull.
So I want whatever the highest of those is.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it looks like that's going to be ride then.
Start with ride.
So I'm just rolling against it to see if I pass the.
You're
going to
try and pass it. Yeah, exactly.
All right. Roll that little shiny ball.
What is it?
That is a 5.
Out of
whoa.
80.
Yeah.
Huh.
So that's a pass.
That's bad.
Wow.
So one. What's the next one?
So if I don't have hate chaos, so I guess I have to roll devotion storm bolt.
Sure. Okay. Seven, yeah.
Oh, that's a good cast.
Okay, and number three?
Well, I stopped listening when you were telling me the skills. I was like, trying to, which skills is what?
How's your battle? Is your battle good?
Yes.
Okay, or any of your cultural weapons. So you can roll a weapon skill.
Ah, okay. Well, they're close, but yeah.
It's a cultural weapon.
Any weapon that was part of my set of...
Pretty much, yeah.
Mine included the pole lasso.
Oh! Mm-hmm.
Ooh. All right.
That is 85?
That's exactly what it is.
Wow.
85.
Okay. Well done.
Hooray. So I pass on
you
the
pass
test?
The test. Great. So donate 20 lunars.
I think that won't be a problem anymore.
Right. Loaded. Okay, good. And sacrifice a point of power. And increase your rune points to 4.
You have to give a point of power.
Yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
That's how the gods stay powerful.
Do I get power back at any point?
You can increase power, actually, yes. Okay. So.
I shouldn't complain. My power's really high, actually.
Mm-hmm. Mine's not so high. I don't know what high. It was a 12, now it's an 11, which I think is not great.
Mine's average.
Mine's 13.
Because it's on a scale of 20.
Yeah.
How would that necklace have worked? You said you lose 3 POW permanently?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's,
but it boosts your strength.
Right, but
six.
You need POW for what? Like defense and stuff?
Well, fighting off possession.
Mostly, yeah, spiritual armor.
By the way, congratulations on your possession.
Oh! Yay.
Why is that?
Are you going to try making your bitch?
What's that?
Are you going to try and make it your bitch this winter season?
The
parasite.
The parasite, yeah.
Good.
Maybe. Can I?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Your pappy.
He's
like,
talking about
yeah.
it,
and I was like super sus.
Yeah.
It's going to be your fetch, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
The fetch, yeah.
Yay. Look, and it's a cold.
Cold, yeah.
I thought it was brain fever.
No,
cold?
That was the
creeping,
first one.
Creeping chills.
Creeping chills, yes.
Creeping chills.
Aww. Yeah.
No. There was a brain fever, but you killed that bitch.
Yes.
Yeah, the brain fever was destroyed.
All right, so I passed your test.
Yeah.
So I donated $20.
Yep.
Can she join the cult as
yeah,
an initiate?
Yeah, you're in.
Right. Boom!
So you're now an initiate.
Yeah.
Does that go on the sheet somewhere?
Yep.
It goes under cults and then rank. The top, I mean, it's on the right side under cults, and then there's this cult and rank right next to it.
Now, how do you stack the ranks?
There's just different requirements. So, like, for then that, you know, if you want to become a rune priest, then you have to be an initiate to begin with, and then you have to have at least 5 rune points, have a POW of 18 or higher, have a skill of 50% or higher in worship deity, the temple has to have a vacancy, you know, stuff like that. If you want to become a god talker, other things, et cetera, et cetera.
I mean, that sounds cool.
Then there's rune lords, cool. Then there's rune lord priests.
Oh my god, I want to be called rune lord.
Yeah, Gringle is a rune lord.
Yeah.
Fucking Gringle.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, we gotta, someone has to make that up to him.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm an initiate, so now what?
I'm looking here. What would be a good rune spell here? So there's Cure Chaos Wound, which can be stacked with any spell used to cure a wound or other affliction received from a chaotic creature. And then also completely cures the victim of brew impregnation.
Ew. Like that.
And removes its consequences.
Wait a minute.
It also cures diseases received from a chaotic creature.
Like STIs?
Brew AIDS,
yeah.
Yes.
It really is the worst AIDS.
Yes.
Although the virus looks like a little goat's head. That's kind of cute.
Just turns you into a brew is what happens.
Yeah.
And it itches. It itches a lot.
I have a desire to hump a rock now.
I don't think anything done. They're just,
I don't think they do. I think they literally just screw everything all the time.
They do. There's also face chaos. When cast upon a single fighter, this person stands their ground and fights any chaotic foe they face, even if they would ordinarily chosen to flee. In general, the spell is used on outsiders, since Stormbolt cultists stand against chaos regardless of fear. But, you know, it's helpful for getting your friends to stick around.
I don't
around.
Know that I want to force my friends to face chaos.
Stand with me, you coward!
And
okay.
No, I don't want
to.
You would just be like, no.
Yeah, while you're punching.
If you ask nicely, maybe I will.
Let's see.
You did turn your recording back on, right?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for asking. Let's see here. The ban one is only castable by high priests, but I'm just looking for other ones. Impede chaos. The target of the spell becomes... Oh, you have that one, okay. Let's see. Just looking for anything with chaos in it here. Regrow limb, that's handy.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Don't cut out all the non-chaotic spells.
Yeah. Well, if we don't find something here on my first go through, I'll just hand you the book.
Regrow head.
You can page through it. Yeah. Not really seeing anything. Tame bull.
I'll take it.
It's literally about calming a bull.
Wait, is there a thing that will let me ride the flying cows?
Tame bull, probably.
Would that actually let me ride the flying cows?
I'm just imagining the little logo for Buffalo Wild Wings.
Yes! Kaba on top and the two cat
silhouettes. Yeah.
Oh my god.
There's something called warding, which creates an area of safety for those inside. Doesn't say anything specifically about chaos. Alright, well, I'll hand you the book.
I think Cure Chaos probably sounds like
the
important
thing
okay.
to do.
Sure. Yeah. Cure Chaos Wound.
Yep.
You got it.
Make it happen.
Because you're saying I can stack that with my other healing skills so that I can actually...
Yes.
Okay.
That's cool.
That's the thing to do.
Excellent.
And then also to brew a Bortificant.
Yeah.
Get rid of it.
Need a brew abortion? Come to Kaba's place.
It gets rid of the brew post-embryo. Alright, so...
We gotta get back to our.
No, hopefully you get rid of the.
We can't say the F word, right?
Yeah, it's true.
Ooh,
maybe you can like also learn some sort of like mind wipe
mind
spells.
Ooh,
they don't have to remember the word.
That's very important.
That would be good.
All right, so yes, those are things that happened.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously,
hand. What about the possession? The
yeah. Oh, we'll get to that.
Oh, yeah.
We'll get to that.
Yeah. I assumed so.
Yep.
All right.
Yep. So, as we've all noted, Hand once again is not present. That's because he went off to deliver.
He got brew aids.
He's a brew now.
How do you spell relief? Brew aids. Not really.
I got it. You didn't have to explain the joke.
Brew
box?
Get it.
Brew box. What
a brew box.
Turning into.
But yes, he departed for Apple Lane with his golden bird cage.
Uh-huh.
And then word came back to you that not only did Gringle accept the gift, but actually took Hend in as a sort of an apprentice.
Oh, wow.
I'm imagining him, like, chortling and like, oh, you pulled a good one.
Yeah, exactly.
The door slowly closing and being like, and now you're my apprentice. I was going to go, Nope.
Now
you're my apprentice. Does that mean he has to stand behind the fern now?
Yeah. He has to be the fern for 2 months. That's the training. You have to be the fern.
Be the fern.
Be the fern you wish to see.
I feel
the
fern.
Mr. Miyagi thing. Was
yeah.
Fern on.
Hand is.
No, it would curl. That's what it would.
Yeah.
Right.
He just puts weight in his hand. Be a fern. Okay.
Hand is due to be married sacred time.
That's
to,
right.
To Bera. So you're all.
This beard.
You're all looking.
You're a little because we all know it's actually.
Yes.
What's that?
What?
I'm laughing. Like, do any of us think that this is funny? Is this
the wedding?
Like,
the wedding? The marriage?
That you know,
it's a sham.
Marriage.
It is a sham, but
actually,
you know,
there are multiple types of marriage in Orlanthe society.
Can he marry a fox woman if he wanted to?
I suppose he could.
So I guess it really matters.
Yeah, that's my question.
Two. Depends on the type of marriage, really.
What? Wait, there's different types of marriages?
Yes.
I could marry like what? Like marry the war llama?
No, not like that.
Can you marry for like different reasons? Like you can actually marry not for love, but just for
exactly. Or you can marry just for love and have it be platonic, but you're in love with each other.
Your BFF.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
The ultimate bromance.
Mm-hmm. There's like a bed spouse. There's a love spouse.
Wow.
All kinds of stuff like that.
Wait, can work something out with the giant.
Ugh.
Yes.
Can I marry a giant?
Yeah, sure.
But is this like so tough that you really could like marry anything?
It's a group marriage?
No. You couldn't marry anything. It's more about like within Orlanthe society itself.
There's always like a dyad, or is it like?
There are others where it's like sometimes the woman in the marriage is the sort of recognized as being the property holder. Sometimes property is held in common. Sometimes the man's property holder.
But no, do they like? Are there like group marriages?
There are multiple marriages.
Okay.
Yeah, not necessarily but group marriages. Not group.
So right. It's always between two entities.
One or more, or two or more entities. Yeah, but
what?
But like one at a time. One at a time.
Right. So in other words, like we three could not get married. We could get married, and we could get married, and you could get married, but we can't all be married under the same like bond.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense. And so once you have that like marriage of a certain type with someone, you can't have like you can have other types of marriages at the same time.
You could negotiate different types of marriages.
But not the same type? Like, can you only have one bed spouse at a time?
No.
Oh, I'm sure you could.
Well, what is the point of getting married at all? Just like
it's to acknowledge the union. It's to acknowledge the partnership.
Literal wet union.
It is to acknowledge that kinship.
Okay.
That's what I'm picturing, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
So. Mm. Mm-hmm.
So Papa's getting married to Big Club, and Ken is getting married to the girl that from his village.
Okay, so I pick Eli up by the neck, and I take him to the bar.
Whoa, where are we going?
And I'm like, we'll be right back, we won't miss much of the ceremony.
Whoa.
And I sit him down at a bench, and I order two beers, and I stick one in front of him and one in front of me, and I'm like, Eli, seriously, you've got to stop trying to marry me off to giants. I can't take it anymore, okay?
Literally can't
take it. I'm really busy. Gross voice on the wind. Look, I heard that.
We can get a special time.
I am busy setting up my shrine. I've just become an initiate. I do not have time for giant romance, okay?
Here's the thing. So I'm going to take a long sip of my beer since it's on you. I'll have another one, please. I totally chug it down.
Yeah.
Here's the thing.
Uh-huh.
The reason I keep bringing it up is because I felt and I saw with my own eyes the feelings that Big Club BC had for you. So I'm not making fun. He genuinely likes you. And I think if you find something like that, you need to grab it by the nuts. And
because he likes you.
He does like you.
And you thought he was kind of hot at first.
He's
very handsome. Nice. He has ice blue eyes.
Eli, just because someone has ice eyes and a nice tushy doesn't mean that you should marry them.
But he has a great jaw, too.
I don't know. That's
like a package deal.
I know. That to me.
He owns property.
The package is not a great deal. He's literally totally the package.
Look, there's. I'm just saying that he had genuine feelings for you, and I was just trying to be supportive of his feelings.
I appreciate your support. If he ever shows up in this town, I will let you know, and I will think about it. But in the meantime,
I'm sure I'll know. I think we'll all know when he shows up.
Feel it coming.
Yeah. So I'm gonna chug my second beer and order a third.
Going back to the wedding.
One more beer, please.
Rather sit through a sham wedding than this.
So here's the marriages. Marriage among the Orlanthe is a mutual bond between participants. It is both exclusive and monogamous. Since sexuality is relatively open and unmarried sex not frowned upon, the marriage bond is significant. Since marriage is sanctified by divine oath, adultery is frowned upon and sometimes dangerous. Divorce is common and available to husband or wife. Traditional law oversees the division. We're done. Traditional law.
The fact they're like, oh, marriage is a big deal, but it's pretty common.
Yeah. Well, it's like when you recognize it's not working out, you know. Traditional law oversees the division of shared property in a divorce. The wife always returns home with her dowry, and the groom always recovers the bride price, except in cases of marriage breach. Seven classes of marriage are recognized. Husband and wife. Husband and wife, both participants have equal property status and responsibility. The woman moves to her husband's house and the children belong to his clan. Husband and underwife. The husband has more status and property and consequently more say in what goes on. The woman moves to her husband's house, the children belong to his clan.
Why would anyone sign up for that?
Because you don't have a good circumstance. Like, probably Hen's marriage she's probably an underwife.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Wife and under-husband. The wife has more status and property and consequently more say in decision-making. The man moves to the wife's house and the children belong to his It must be her clan. Her clan. I'm sure that's a type. Yeah. As Rolian husband, the wife has more status and property than the husband. The man moves to his wife's house. Ah, I see. So that is different. So wife and under-husband, the children belong to his clan, but in as Rolian husband, the man moves to the wife's house and the children belong to her clan.
Okay.
Year wife or year husband. This is a temporary marriage. Renewable after a year.
Subject to
terms listed above.
Yeah.
That's actually how I think marriage should be.
I know. Renewable on a yearly basis.
Yeah,
let's
check in every year, make sure we're still
cool. Uh-huh. I think so.
Bed wife or bed husband. No property changes hands save for that publicly granted with witness. The children are raised by the individual who is not named in the title. Thus, a bed husband is not responsible for raising the children.
So it's basically just a live-in sex buddy.
Mm-hmm. And love wife. No property changes hands, even unto going to the children of the pair, a vow of monogamy for its own sake or the sake of romantic love. Children go to the father's plan.
That is very Pendragon.
Yeah.
So what's it like in Prax?
Yeah.
It's a whole other deal. Which I don't have the information on.
Damn right it. So if I marry Big Club, it would be Azrolian because fuck that shit.
I would say yearly because, you know.
Well, Azrolian is very specific. That means you are an actual like priestess of Azrolian. Yeah.
So you should do a yearly deal. Come on.
Try it out
for a year.
Oh my god. If you guys are so intrigued by the sex life, go have one of your own.
I can't. I'm a eunuch.
That's incredibly insensitive of you.
You could take a love wife.
Here's the thing. Here's how I feel about it. I stand by my argument, is that I saw him have genuine feelings for you, and I wanted to convey that.
Love.
That's all. Bye. Ooh, so after my fourth beer, I'm out of there.
Awesome. Hey, man, I already stomped back off to the champagne.
Oh, you did?
Yes, because I was like, fuck this shit.
But you're still talking to me. You're talking to the bartender, too. Like,
yeah.
And I'll tell you another thing.
Yeah. That's
right. He's on her tab.
You're
so
drunk at this point, you don't realize I'm not there. You're just, listen, he had feelings for you. And the bartender's like, what the fuck, man?
Yeah.
I think the bartender's used to me talking.
Yeah,
he's just like,
true. Uh-huh. Eli's drunk again.
Yeah. I'm not drunk. I can handle myself.
My con is 18.
You love the idea that you're sitting there like, I'm a drunk, and you just totally elbow miss the bar.
Can I do a con roll?
Con times five, please.
Yep.
Be wasted.
Con times five is 90.
Oh, you're fine.
89.
So you're like, most drunk.
But your size, you're pretty small, right?
I'm tiny.
So, yeah.
I'm teetering, but still holding my
slurring. You're not slurring. Tough little guy, though.
No, I'm tough.
Yep.
I'm skinny, but I'm strong.
Anyway, it's a moot point if he doesn't show back up, which probably he will.
I like that you're kind of like leaving like a, like, oh, if he shows
if
up.
If he shows up.
I'll consider it.
Yeah,
I will consider all things if they become presented to me.
Even the butternut squash. All right, so.
Worst imagery ever.
I think it's the best. Have you seen a butternut squash? It is festive and it's very penis-like. All right, so moving on. It looks like a peen.
It does not look like a real peen. It looks like a cartoon peen.
But still peen.
Still peen.
So.
This is where you come for your fantasy penis talk.
That's right.
We should just start a separate fucking show that's just.
What's its peen?
What's its peen? Well, like,
that should be a characteristic.
Yes. What's that, Jade?
Just we can figure out an algorithm based on, like, charisma and app and things like that.
Oh, yeah.
Peen size.
And then a separate stat for likelihood of actual
and also
sexual
race.
Attraction.
All right, I'm just going to say right now, there is a role-playing game whose name shall not be uttered.
Whose name
shall not be uttered that has tables for determining penis size, anal circumference, vaginal circumference, and depth, nipple diameter, nipple length. We're not going to get into that. I'm just saying, it already exists.
We'd be the softcore version. It would just be chat about... No, we would just chat about what's their peen, that's it.
And then there's mechanics for comparing the penis girth to the vaginal capacity, and if the penis girth is too big, it causes damage, and so on and so forth, so...
Why did you have to bring that up?
Hey, because we're talking all about...
Because they're starting to pitch the idea.
We had that conversation last week.
It's been done.
Because we got into a whole discussion about whether Kava could have sex with
I know, I was there.
That's what
I
that's
I like imagining that people can like submit their own characters and we like, you know,
assess.
Who would Kava have sex with?
No, just on like their character stats, as it were.
And then I want to send them, the way I want to send it to them is artistic interpretation. So I send them the emoji fruit or vegetable that I think that it is.
No.
So you get a mushroom, eggplant, a lime, a piece of watermelon.
All right, so anyway, we're going to move along. Yes, we're going to move along.
We spent another 20 minutes on the topic. Basically.
So, Renee, do you want to see if Karya can become a full shaman?
Yes.
Okay.
It's her dream.
All right. So what is your pow?
Okay. It is 17.
What is your chaw?
Oh, 6.
Okay.
Whoa. Yeah. The scar, man. It just, yeah.
Yep.
Hey, right. It makes you very sexy.
Oh. Thanks.
Oh. You're going to take an average.
Sexiness just ties me to this world. And I'm not.
Yeah, no. Yeah.
Not right. So you take an average of that.
Yeah.
Take an average of that times 5, so that's 60. So please roll 60 or less to see if you are worthy this year.
Ooh. 60 or less. Go, Karya. You got this.
Yay. Oh, 34.
Nice.
Yay.
All right. Great. All right. So the most important aspect of becoming a shaman is awakening your fetch.
All right.
So this awakening proceeds through a series of stages.
Me too. Just making fetch happen.
Mm-hmm. All right. Like so to begin, you go to a holy place and enter a meditative trance.
All right.
So that would probably be out on the Kalimar wilds where you've traversed before. Out amongst the death and desolation of the wild.
Okay, yeah. I stayed with Dad, then I left the next morning out into the...
Exactly. You fast, you pray to the greater entity to awaken the powers within. Mm-hmm. And let's see, your former mentor may create and maintain an Axis Mundi within which the stage takes place. Yeah, so excellent. So your father builds... Or? Yeah, your father builds a little, or raises a little bin here for you.
Okay.
You know, to meditate under.
Is he like, it's a single tear because he's so proud?
Oh.
No, I think he's so far gone at this point. He's just like, here.
Yeah.
This is what you do.
Yeah,
this is what you do. And he expected it to happen eventually.
Of course.
I think you'd be disappointed if it didn't.
Yes.
So you remain in a trance for 2 days.
Okay.
At which point the horned man, the first shaman, appears before you.
Oh my god.
Mm-hmm. He tells you it is time to begin.
Oh shit.
You then discorporate.
Turn yourself, right? Or...
Hmm?
Sorry.
Oh, yeah. Right, yes. you then discorporate, and the horned man escorts your spirit along the great path.
Oh, great.
Along the path, you undergo the remaining stages.
Okay.
So, you approach the threshold of the frontier region. Here, the applicant sacrifices Pau to the great entity as a demonstration of the applicant's dedication and humility in the face of these great powers. These Pau points are permanently taken from the current Pau of the applicant, and a corresponding number of magic points are also deducted.
What?
These points become the starting Pau of the shaman's fetch at the end of this ritual.
Ooh, cool!
There is no minimum that must be sacrificed, but a fetch with only 1 or 2 points of Pau is easily destroyed if it must combat spirits attacking the fetch or the shaman. Here, the horned man leaves the applicant, as the applicant must find their way to the next stage alone.
Hmm. So does the fetch sort of become like a spirit screen?
Yes.
Like it
sounds like.
Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's cool.
Yep. So, how much Pau do you want to?
Maybe 4.
Okay.
Would that reduce me too much?
It's up to you. If you have Pau 17, that would reduce you to 13. That's not bad. It's still a bit above average.
Okay. I'll go for that.
Okay.
Yeah. Come on, yellow fetch. Mm-hmm. And that's the equivalent from...
from your magic points as well, yeah.
But you're sort of not losing the magic points in terms of defense. You're just losing them in terms of cast ability.
It goes over to the fetch, yeah. Right. Exactly.
Oh, great. What's that
there? All right, so... all right, so you... also, as the horned man departs, he gifts you with a bone rattle.
Oh, great.
Mm-hmm.
Is that for the Rattleborn?
No, not. Yeah, I was telling Jade about this. Another bit. I'm always, you know, you read up on Glorantha, you're just always coming across new bits of lore. So the Orlanthi have these magical rattles that they can place in the crib of a baby if they're short on warrior muscle power. Like, you know, if they've had a lot of guys die last year and they need some more warriors really fast.
So you put a rattle in the baby's crib, and it accelerates the baby's growth. So that within 2 weeks, it's like a mature adult.
What?
But its emotional development is not nearly as fast. So no. it's basically this like super buff warrior with the brain of like a 3-year-old.
Oh yeah.
And so they're called the Rattleborn.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's perfect. Yeah. You know, you just don't feed them for like just feed them late. You know, and then right. they get a tantrum and they go and kill.
Exactly. Yeah, like, that's perfect. It. That's it.
And I was saying like yeah. toddlers are assholes.
So, yeah.
Oh man.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh man.
Oh yeah.
Then how do you get them to
you
stop?
Don't even know.
They're like on a rampage and they like.
Well, yeah. You you just
let them get tired. That's all you can do.
Oh, she just has to wear herself out.
Yes.
I mean,
the Rattleborn. The Rattleborn has to wear themselves out.
Yes.
No, this is just your personal sort of ceremonial instrument.
Sorry,
I think my face is all red.
All right, so you continue on the path.
Yes.
Until you reach a cave.
Okay.
It is a location in the spirit world that is both literal and symbolic.
Yes, I'll be reborn.
What does the cave look like,
yeah.
Takaria? What kind of cave is it?
Mm. As far as the shape?
Mm-hmm. Mm. Or just anything. Like, for instance, a shaman in Prax might see an oasis, and they descend into the water of the oasis.
Ooh,
you know?
Neat.
Or there might be a giant oak tree, and the cave is under.
Oh, perfect. Okay.
Yeah.
It looks like a grave.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah.
Perfect.
Nice.
All right, so you climb down into the loamy soil of the grave, and it is a visual representation of the applicant's inner strength as well as the applicant's most despised weakness.
Oh.
No.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So as you...
So real.
I know. This is
deep.
Very well detailed and incredibly, I'd say, borderline accurate.
Okay. So as you descend into the grave, you feel spirits circling around you.
Okay.
Right? And they're whispering questions in your ear.
Oh.
So one of them asks, who deserves greater loyalty, your king or yourself?
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Can I look at my passions?
Yes, of course.
Oh,
yes,
okay.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Let's see. King or myself? King?
Okay.
Yeah,
king?
Hmm.
Another one asks you, is it better to shield your fetch from prying eyes or proudly display your powers for all to see?
No, hide. Shield. Shield the fetch.
All right. So, so you reach the bottom of the grave, and it's like much deeper than it seemed. You know, so like you look up and there's just a tiny little postage stamp of light above you,
okay.
You know, and you're at the bottom of this very dark grave. And so now you must attempt a summon spirit skill roll. The skill can be augmented by ritual practices. The results of the roll determine details about your fetch.
Can be or cannot be?
Hmm?
Can be or cannot?
Can be. So just to remind you, let's see here. You can sacrifice a valuable object. You can sacrifice a living thing. You can sacrifice magic points.
Okay. I had a, let's see. The staff
mm-hmm.
that I had.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot to look up the value. I have 25 leave right here.
Okay. Fine. Good.
Did you get some cows?
Yeah.
Mm.
Gotta sacrifice that big thing because you're super into death.
Yeah.
I thought you had.
Did get some cows.
I think everyone got cows.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think we all chose some cows.
Yeah. And I wouldn't know what to do with them anyway, so. Can I just slaughter them all?
Jesus. How much do I get for mass slaughtering
yes.
cows?
Extra bonus.
I mean, a cow will give you plus 20.
Oh, sweet.
Do okay. cows stack?
Plus 20.
Yeah, do they?
I'd say it stacks, sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
How many can I sacrifice?
I just many as you. I mean,
well, if you do
five would give you plus 100.
Okay, so. Let's do that.
All right,
do it.
So, yeah, so somewhere, down. Somewhere out of the, somewhere out on the commons, out on the fields, five cows suddenly keel over.
Oh, you know? Great, cool.
Maybe we're all walking by and like, holy fuck.
Yeah. Oh. Wait, was the backdrop for the wedding?
Yeah,
this idyllic field, and like these cows start just.
Yeah.
Just toppling over.
That's not a bad omen at all for your marriage.
No, I'm sure.
Well,
this
will
be
no. just fine.
Okay, so plus one. Well, do you want to sacrifice your staff as well or keep that?
I guess I'll keep it.
Okay, so plus 100 to your summon spirit skill. Go ahead and roll. Okay. Basically, you just don't want to roll a fumble at this point.
Oh my okay. God. Oops, I forgot to look up. Where's summon spirit?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's plus 100.
Yeah, so just don't roll a 96 or above.
Oh, 67.
Very good.
Okay.
All right.
There you
so.
Go. Yeah, 99.
All right. Actually, we do kind of need to know, just so we know whether I was a special or not. I doubt it was, but summon spirit, yes.
So it's
100
what
plus.
What happens if it's a special?
Let's see here.
It becomes more powerful than you can even imagine.
You're on our side, right?
You'll never turn on us, will you?
Where is your summon spirit skill?
Is it a thing? Oh, is it a spell?
Well, if it's a spell, then it would just be my magic points.
Yeah, exactly. Right? No, it says summon spirit skill.
I don't see it on here.
Is it one that you have to write in?
Maybe. Maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it's under worship as like a... No, I guess it's like a thing.
Hmm.
Yeah,
I'm not seeing it. Or an other skill.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
Or under spirit magic?
Spirit lore?
Is it under spirit magic? No. Spirit combat?
It's not on this list. I thought summoning stuff, like summoning elementals is a rune skill, right?
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Shamanic skills, spirit combat, spirit lore, spirit travel, spirit dance. Right?
Right. Mm-hmm. That's just all up under magic, and there's nothing there that says summon spirit.
Well, you know, we're working with the pre-publication manuscript here. I'm just going to have to assume that's a typo.
So call it a certain number?
Let's go with spirit lore. Does that sound good to you?
Sure.
All right. So what is your spirit lore?
24.
All right. So you were at 124.
Yeah.
So a special success would have been a 25 or less.
Right.
All
right.
So okay. That's a regular success. So the fetch's beginning power is the power that you sacrificed. So
okay.
Four.
Four.
And then roll 3d6.
3d6. Mm-hmm. Go.
10? 10, so that's its charisma.
Okay.
And then you give me three possible spirit.
It has better charisma.
I know,
than
I
think.
Disease has better charisma than you.
What an insult, my
I love
God.
That.
Your
I
disease
love
has more fucking charisma.
I
than
love
you do.
That. I love
too.
That. It's perfect.
No, I think Karya would be. Mm-hmm. Fine with that.
Yeah.
Who needs charisma?
Yeah, right.
Well, if the spirit's gonna do like weird, creepy things, it should have some element of like, ooh, like you're kind of transfixed by it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's before it attacks you or does something weird.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then you give me three possible spirit animals and I choose one.
Three spirit animals?
Yes, and I'll choose the one that it manifests.
Is there a
as.
List of spirit okay. animals to choose? Just
any?
Just choose
any spirit animal.
Oh, choose a gecko.
A gecko.
It was a creeping chill,
creeping
right?
Chills.
Yeah. Right, so,
yeah,
so what would a disease spirit manifest as?
Octopus.
It's too much like the octopus.
I don't know. A bird?
Creeping chills?
I don't know.
Could be like a
pig.
A salamander?
Pigs have diseases.
Or a snake, honestly.
A snake?
I think creeping chills,
oh.
Like...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The Orlanthi associate black birds with death. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well...
Let's go with that. A raven.
Raven.
A
snake.
Snake.
And I need a third one.
Oh, you need a third one. Oh,
Wombat? A cow.
Yeah, wombat.
Or
a cat.
An
a
owl?
Cow.
A cow.
It's
an
also
owl.
It's a
an owl.
Of death in some
yeah.
cultures.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Owl?
Yeah. Owl. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Depending on the type of owl.
Yeah, owls are definitely.
Do you want it to be a flying thing? Probably, right?
I guess so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alright. And I choose one. I will
okay.
choose. Ooh, that's a tough choice.
You just get to choose whichever one you want.
Gecko.
Yeah.
Gecko.
No, no, of the three that she gave.
Oh, oh, okay.
I like one of the roll three. I'm gonna choose something completely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you spend all that time?
Right. Oh, I thought I was gonna have to roll for
a fish.
I just wanted to know what you thought.
Curious. Beat a fish. I want to know how disappointed you'd be.
Wait, so it'd be Magikarp, basically.
Yeah, like Magikarp.
How it just be.
All right, so we're gonna go with the snake.
Okay, great.
Yes. It is.
It's chthonic.
Yes.
Oh, it's you can also associate it with death. And
yep. So it is a black snake.
Ooh,
plus, I'm picturing it kind of entwined around your forearm. And
oh,
like,
perfect.
You know.
Yes.
So.
Great. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes. In your character portrait, doesn't she have like one of those?
I think
like,
she does.
Oh,
Harley.
Yes.
You?
Oh, yeah.
Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Nice.
Do I?
Yeah, maybe that's just what people see it as.
Yeah.
Like an
armband.
Or maybe it like grew. Like she actually has an armband tattoo, but now the spirit.
Yeah, you do have like little bracers and that.
Okay. So it's actually now my snake.
Yeah, exactly.
Cool.
So basically, the fetch's pow is still your. It's like it's added to your pow, so you still do essentially have a 17.
Okay.
Right. It's just the fetch has four of those points.
Okay.
And if you'd rolled a special or a critical, you would have actually increased the pow that you gave it.
Aww.
So. Eh. All right. So you are still within the cave.
Okay.
You have summoned your fetch. The fetch has responded.
Oh.
But now the bad man arrives.
Here we go.
To test the resolve
of
the applicant.
Mm-hmm. So it's probably like a Luciferian type.
Yeah.
I would imagine.
Right.
She's comfortable. She embraces the dark.
Mm-hmm.
Some shiny dude coming up.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, so.
You know.
This guy dressed in white. And
do you want to look deliciously and all that?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, glitter.
Okay, so we're gonna
like Twilight hanging out over his stupid head.
Yeah.
we're gonna do some spirit combat here.
Oh yes!
Yay.
Bring it.
Make it happen.
Bring it, shiny guy.
Okay.
Are they opposed rolls?
So let's see here. At the end of any single round, game master gets nothing. Until the number of rounds. okay, so I have secretly determined how many rounds he will fight you. And
secretly.
Let's see.
15.
In each round, a winner and loser is determined. No magic points are lost. If the bad man wins the round, the player must choose a taboo from the taboo table.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Oh, cool.
The game master may make the choice for the player. If the shaman wins the round, shaman gains a single shamanic ability and skips the need to take a corresponding taboo.
Ooh.
Player need not choose which shamanic ability at this point. They may be chosen later. Okay, so let's do it.
All right.
You can do it.
Spirit combat.
Okay, so yeah, you're going to roll against your spirit combat. Barrel of hand.
85.
Ooh.
That's a fail.
A fail?
Oh, no, it's not? Sweet Jesus.
Wrong.
All right.
Oh, you thought you won that round? You're wrong.
Please.
All right. How well did you succeed?
85 out of 100. Okay. I use my modifier, right?
Which modifier?
The magic
modifier.
Plus 10.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then 85
out of 100.
Okay. Let me just figure out his thresholds here. Okay, so. Great. He got a special success, so that means he wins.
Okay.
So you have to pick a taboo. Would you like to roll randomly?
Sure.
Random roll.
Out of nowhere.
96.
96.
Whoa.
Okay.
Never bathe.
Never bathe! Well, she doesn't bathe anyway, so that's
right. I was gonna say, I think you're smelly anyway.
Yeah. She hangs out in the graveyard and, forgets.
Never
hygiene already.
So. Wait, so like never, so because that's a taboo, does that mean if she's covered in like all kinds of like gristle and guts?
Never bathe.
What if you accidentally
what about
never
what
bathe?
What if
you
get rained on?
Sponging?
Never bathe.
What constitutes
bathing? Exactly.
Yeah. Like getting caught.
Purposely
rain?
Cleaning yourself.
Okay, but
she can never blow her nose again if she gets a cold.
Nope.
Oh.
Right.
Wait, blowing your nose isn't bathing.
It's cleansing yourself.
Purposefully cleansing yourself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But getting caught in the rain, that's fine.
Caught in the rain, or if you fall into a pond.
Falling into a pond is fine.
Getting pushed into a pond?
Oh my god.
Yeah.
She's just gonna push you in ponds all the time.
Right,
like,
no.
God,
Greek. All right, let's move it along.
Oh, I could get another taboo?
Oh, well, okay, actually, sorry. You get a choice. Do you want to break off the spirit combat right now or keep going?
Why would I want to break it off?
Because you're getting your butt kicked.
Thanks, Shane.
Oh, no, let's go.
No, all right. Come on.
Go.
Fight.
Oh, man. 78.
All right. I, again, got a special success. No, so.
More taboo.
No. Yay.
Bloop. What did I get? A 7. Why did I roll?
All right. This one's a little less onerous. Never eat bison meat.
Oh, okay.
Well, you don't know what you're missing.
Yeah, man.
Wait, what happens if it happens, though?
Bison.
Like, she accidentally eats a bison meatball, like, at a party?
Like, she doesn't know, like, what's the penalty?
Or accidentally bathe myself.
Does she, like, lose her fetch, or she just, like, gets scolded by
something? I'm just imagining a little, like, mini lightning bolt is like, no!
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It feels wrong. It feels wrong as you're doing it.
I would say you probably lose access to things for a while.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Or it's like a penance, maybe?
Yeah,
like
you have to do a penance. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Keep a whip, you know.
All right, do you want to keep going?
Yes!
Okay.
Go, Renee!
Wow, I am on fire.
I'm not!
What did you roll?
86!
Okay.
All right, I got another special success, so.
Yay! More taboos! More taboos! More taboos.
14?
I've seen this. That's meant to be taboo.
I've been there. Yeah.
All right, remain celibate during sacred time.
Oh, okay.
You're like, thank God.
Well, I never bathe, so.
Yeah, well.
Does corpse fucking count as
sacred? Yes, it does.
Just checking. Jesus. Yeah, just checking.
Corpse fucking. All right, so.
Can't wait.
What do you phrase with that? All
right, do you want to keep going?
Yes.
All right.
Go, 7!
Yes!
Finally!
Alright, well, I also got a special success. Wow. However, since you're the initiator, you win the tie.
Wait, yes. Is yours a critical success?
No, it's not.
No.
Would that be a 5?
I think so. Wait, yeah. What is a critical? Is it a 1%?
Yeah, 2? I think so.
Or is it 2%?
It's
2%, so then that would be a 4.
Okay.
4 or less.
We're all rooting for that 4.
I know.
Okay, so you get a shamanic ability, right?
Ooh, yes.
Yay!
You can bake whenever you want. You're self-cleaning somehow.
Right.
The dirt just bounces off.
Right off.
Yeah.
This is why I'm wondering if bathe really just means water, because if it does, you could dirt bathe like a chinchilla.
I'd say dirt bath would be...
Purposefully cleansing, though.
I don't know, ashes.
I think water is the implication.
Okay, so as long as you clean yourself with water.
Oh, okay.
All right, so.
I like the ash idea. It's very absorbent.
Yeah. Here are your abilities. Here are your abilities.
It's that soft, ghostly color.
Yeah.
Creepy.
Choose one of these. Conceal fetch. Cure disease. Expanded presence.
Ooh, yes.
Hide soul.
What?
Ooh.
Materialize fetch.
Aww.
Magic attack. Magic defense.
There's a lot.
Possession.
Wait, like she can possess people?
Could I possess somebody?
Yes, it does. Yes, that's what it means.
Yes, that's what I want.
All right, we'll just stop there.
Okay. All right.
I was gonna say we didn't get the squeal response or anything else.
I'm just gonna go through the rest just so.
Okay.
I'm gonna go through the rest just so you
can
kind
of know. I'll give
them
all a fair shake. All right.
Power within. That's kind of like an instant, like what it's what you wanted last session. It gives you extra magic points with just a little bit of concentration.
Oh, okay.
Second sight. Self-resurrection.
Whoa.
Show spirit. Soul expansion. Spell barrage. Spell extension. Spirit affinity. Spirit defense. Spirit mastery.
Some cool stuff.
Yep.
Yeah, it is cool. So what is the expansion, just out of curiosity?
Soul expansion?
Yeah, either of the expansions.
Presence.
Oh, yeah.
Expanded presence.
Does it just make me seem bigger?
That gives your fetch extra charisma.
Oh.
And
you still can't make yourself sexy.
Yeah, no, exactly. Mm.
And then soul expansion gives you +1 to your maximum POW, but not your actual POW.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Mm. Which would improve your chance to increase POW by experience.
Ah.
Hmm.
Okay. So
no,
do you want to keep...
and none of them come close. That's awesome.
That's pretty good. Do you want to keep going?
I can?
Yes.
Go. Let's go.
Oh, wait, you have a secret number of rounds. Okay, yes. Let's do it.
91.
94.
94?
I got a special again.
Oh!
Okay, after this, I demand to know what this guy is like.
Oh, yeah.
Like, what's the special, like...
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Alright.
21.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
What is your strongest rune?
Oh, no.
Death, right?
I think so. No, actually, man.
Oh, okay.
Death is a close second, though.
Okay.
No, so, but that's Daka Fall's,
Right.
It's man.
Okay, so, remain celibate during a given season.
Like every season?
So it's usually just corresponding to the shaman's strongest rune. Oh, what is your strongest rune? Oh, that's what I just asked. Man. That doesn't have a season associated with it.
Okay, so death is the next one right after that.
Okay. That has a week associated with it, but not a season.
She could just pick a season.
Yeah, what do you want? Sea season, fire season, earth season, dark season, or storm season?
Dark?
Yep, sounds good.
Seems like the worst season to be celibate during. It's probably when everyone wants to bang.
That's when she smells the worst. That's when she smells the absolute worst.
That's true, too.
So right. Every dark season she has to be celibate?
Mm-hmm.
And
she's not
time.
Really,
and
like...
sacred time.
Oh, yeah. And sacred time, yes. And let's see when else I will be celibate.
Like, I want to keep going.
Okay.
Total celibacy.
Nine.
All right. Yes. So you get another power.
Yeah.
So again, conceal fetch, cure disease, expanded presence, hide soul, materialize fetch, magic attack, magic defense, power within, second sight, self-resurrection, show spirit, soul expansion, spell barrage, spell extension, spirit affinity, spirit defense, spirit mastery.
What is spell barrage?
Spell barrage. Each time you take spell barrage, it allows you to throw one additional spirit spell simultaneously.
Oh, okay.
So you could cast two spirit magic spells in the same round.
Okay.
Or the same form.
Awesome. Yeah.
There was also that one that would give you more magic.
Power within. You take one melee round and concentrate, gathering your inner strength. At the end of the round, you lose one hit point and gain one of the following bonuses, plus 1d6 magic points, plus 10% success chance in spell casting for the next 10 rounds.
But I have to take a hit point loss?
Mm-hmm, or ability to cast any one point spirit magic spell, whether memorized or not.
I'll go with spell barrage.
Okay.
Let's see.
All right, so that was round 6, and that is the maximum that it can go, because I rolled a 6, and...
Oh, okay.
So.
Dang, that was fun.
That was really exciting.
All right, so after these stages are complete, the fetch and the shaman are one entity. The horned man escorts the new shaman back to the mundane world.
Woo, cool!
Wow, you're stinky.
I'm a shaman, a stinky shaman.
She cleans herself just not with water.
Yeah, she's really absorbent.
Although
I imagine she's just like gray and black.
Her skin like so soft.
Yeah, but when she's not like weird colors, like she'd just be like ashy looking all the time.
Yeah, definitely.
That sounds ideal for her.
I love it.
It kind of works. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
So as the horned man is escorting you back to the material world.
What kind of horns is he wearing?
I'm picturing like really wide kind of elk antlers.
Oh, okay.
Elk.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I was thinking of the Carnosos. Carnosos is how you would pronounce his name, right?
Mm-hmm.
The spirally. But how about big spirals?
There we go.
Yeah.
Big spirals.
Love it.
Big
horn spirals. Man shows up whatever horns really speak to you.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Covered in ash.
So as he's walking you back, you see something, another figure, kind of walking very slowly, mournfully through the spirit realm, and you recognize it as Hend.
What?
Hend?
Mm-hmm.
What? Why is he? Oh, what the hell?
And he actually has like several wounds upon his body.
What? Wait, what?
Oh wow!
And he just kind of looks at you and then just keeps walking.
Can I catch up to him?
Well,
or am I stuck with the horned man?
You're stuck with the horned man.
Hey, can I call out to him?
Yeah, but he doesn't reply.
Dude, I didn't think he would. I'd have to like go stop him. You know, the spirit world.
Aren't you sitting at his wedding like right now?
Hey man, he's doing other shit in the spirit world.
Is this turned into the Red Wedding?
No, he's just in the spirit world doing his shit, man.
And you actually get one automatic ability, so...
Oh, because I saw him?
No, just because that way you at least get something, even if you rolled all taboos. So, third
Wouldn't
ability.
Wouldn't that be funny?
That would be amazing. Fun.
I just want to see that taboo list.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can't eat chicken on a Sunday.
Yeah, right.
So, what ability
can't
would you like?
Spit on Saturday. What is materialize fetch? Is that...
By performing a 15-minute ritual, the shaman may materialize their fetch for a length of time equal to 15 minutes per point of the ability. So that would be 15 minutes. Okay. When the ability ends, the fetch dematerializes. While corporeal, the fetch may be attacked through normal means, take damage, etc. If the fetch dematerializes while still suffering hit point loss, the fetch may not materialize until fully healed. So basically, it just means that you can bring your snake into the real world.
I love that.
You know, throw it at somebody.
Yeah. Okay, and could it die?
Like, yes, it could die.
It could die, okay. It could die. Well, that's okay. All right, look, materialize fetch sounds great.
Okay. Like, I know where to go find plenty of bone diseases to possess me.
That's right.
I wonder what your kitty cats would think of the snake.
Your pestilent snake?
Yeah. What? All right. What your cats might think of my snake if I materialized it.
Oh. That's right, cats don't really like snakes, do they?
No.
They don't love them.
Not even like cucumbers.
They don't. But these are sentient cats, so maybe if I was like, no guys, it's fine, it's a spirit snake, they might be like, oh.
Yeah.
Why would anyone choose that? Probably just make biting comments.
Aw. Yeah.
Alright, so, very good. So the rest of you are gathered. It is sacred time. The rest
it's
of you
time
are...
Of year. Is it like the winter? Winter?
Like I said, spring equinox falls during sacred time. So it's like...
Okay.
It's still,
the rebirth.
It's still pretty chilly. You know, it's like 60 degrees. Yeah. You know, and... Yeah, it's cold. Because you guys live in a mountain pass.
Yeah,
so
no,
there's still lots of snow up on the peaks.
Yeah, no,
and, you know.
I think it's nice out. I'm outside working on my tan.
Well, of course, you're all actually at the wedding. The tables have been laid out, and you know.
Yeah.
And so you're expecting Hend on this day. In fact, he should have been here much earlier, but he still hasn't shown up.
Oh no.
And,
so because he's my cousin, can I like be talking to my aunt and uncles? Mm-hmm. And, or wait, no.
Okay, is there anyone who's daring to sit next to me?
Yeah, no.
Well, you're not there yet. Actually,
oh, not,
you were doing your ritual during sacred time.
So, okay. My dad married his mom.
Uh huh.
So I'm talking to my dad. Like, where is he? Like,
what's
going on?
There's a lot of speculation.
Yeah. Okay.
He's
running off that fox woman again. No, probably.
So you see a ox cart pulling up outside the wedding area. It is being driven by a man you recognize as Gringle.
Uh-oh.
He's got old Quack John with him as well. They both look fairly mournful.
Him died.
Gringle hops down off the cart and heads over and is talking with, what's her name? Aristha, the wine merchant, the rune priestess of Isseries. Mm-hmm. And Bera,
right.
Who you see start to, she puts her hand to her mouth and she starts crying.
Oh no.
And yes, the word quickly spreads that Hend was killed.
What?
In a fight with some Tusk Raiders who raided Apple Lane. Not Tuscan Raiders.
Just period.
What happened to him being the fern? He should have been safe inside.
Yeah. I know. What happened? So I run up to see what's in the cart.
His body?
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, there is a sort of a casket.
And a constellation fruit basket.
From the Dutch.
We should get the birdcage back, really.
So I go to Gringle and I say, you were supposed to protect him.
What?
He was your apprentice.
So Gringle kind of is a little taken aback and he says, there was nothing we could do. They descended on the town and he wasn't the only one who died.
Am I bigger than Gringle?
Yes.
I walk up and I just stare down at him and I'm like, what the heck happened?
Yeah, I mean, you had that fortress.
They caught us by surprise. We were in the Tin Inn.
No one protected Hend. He's not very good in battle. You know this.
We tried our best.
I'm looking at that.
He couldn't chaw himself out of it.
Yeah.
Beach marks on his body.
Yeah, I'm looking at the duck. I'm like scrutinizing the duck.
The duck looks sad.
Oh wait, are the Tusk Raiders? Are they ducks?
No, they're men who sold out to chaos, and they ride.
Let's kill them all.
I'm furious.
Yeah.
I'm so
let's go
furious.
Get them.
You survive chaos, will they be slain by chaos?
How ironic.
We can resurrect him, right? That's the thing that happens.
Well, it is sacred time.
Karya, you can resurrect him, right? He'll be a weird
Karya comes running up the road.
Karya. Well, you guys could go find her out in the wild.
Yeah, I'm out in the field
somewhere.
Yeah. Let's look for Karya.
Right. Do we have any knowledge between us about like what that means to resurrect? That's like common.
You know of it, sure, right? Yeah.
It's been known to happen.
So sometimes they don't come back all the way.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes they don't.
And only a shaman can do it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, look, wait a minute. Before we go around resurrecting people.
We all know from Pet Cemetery it never goes wrong.
Yes. I just don't know. I mean, this is unfortunate. We're all angry and sad and mad. I'm mad at Gringle.
Certainly we're all saddened by Hen's passing, but...
But do well, we
let's
really,
be realistic here.
Do we really need to resurrect him? I mean, everything happens in its appointed time.
No, people
nobody lives forever. Nobody lives forever.
I'm not going to lie. I think it's what Hen would have wanted.
To be resurrected or to be dead?
How did this happen? Did he say he wanted to be dead?
I'm not giving you any outside information.
I think we should resurrect him.
I don't want to.
His enthusiasm for having someone else's face put on the face of his character. Game.
I will say that the attitude you're expressing is not one that's unknown. Mostly it's worshippers of Humact who believe that the dead should stay dead.
Oh.
Because it's pretty common to resurrect things.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not unusual.
Well,
we can get a shot.
But I think we should.
And worst case scenario,
okay.
If he comes back wrong, let me just kill him again.
That's fine.
That's true.
Okay, fine.
Or
yeah,
he'll just hang
it.
Out in mortality and they'll both just sullenly sit there looking at each other all day long.
Like, I only have like a 25 of death, and so I'm like all about resurrecting it.
Yeah,
bring him back. It'll be great.
He was really excited to get to like re-encounter that merchant duck guy. I mean, I think we ought to give him a chance to do that. We should resurrect
him. Yeah, I thought he already did. That's why he was with Gringle.
No, the merchant duck guy.
Maybe the assassin duck guy?
Assassin duck guy. The mercenary.
Oh,
not merchant. The
yes,
mercenary.
Merganser.
Merganser, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, yeah, I guess
maybe
so.
They'll have a bromance and get married.
Oh. I don't want to resurrect him so he can marry a duck.
I don't think that's what
Hend would not want that.
Plus, this bride is all sad. We gotta resurrect this motherfucker.
Oh, wait, does she come walking up to see his body in the ox cart or the.
Yeah, so Gringle takes the top off the casket.
Oh, is it
bad?
Well, he's in honey.
Oh,
to preserve
doing
that yeah.
thing.
Awesome.
That's really all right. Cool.
Yeah, so he's just lying there submerged under honey, but he has like several slashes and pierce marks. And stuff.
Wait, yeah, I was gonna say,
what
are
you
do you do that?
Distinctively
I'm not there!
He's not there!
All right, okay, let's find Karya and see if we can resurrect Hen.
Yeah.
Let's go!
Yeah. Oh, we should ask what's her butt from the village if it should put the body in the temple or whatever, right?
Yes, so they'll put him in state inside the earth temple.
Okay. Okay, Karya.
Mm-hmm. I was about to be like, where does one get that much honey at last minute?
I know, that's
like, oh no, but Gringle's like one hell of a merchant.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's
got casks.
Couple gallons.
Casks, I tell you.
I give the would-have-been bride my deepest, sincerest condolences, but then I'm like, but you wear his beard anyway, you can do that.
What?
Oh my god. Does she know that?
Does she know what a beard is? Is that a phrase even used?
Pick a different
I'm
going to
say it's the equivalent of
pick a different
beard.
Word. We had talked as a group with Hend about how this was not his true love. And I am not for the conventions of man being a beast-ruined person, so I say to her,
yeah.
You can do better, it's okay. He was.
What is she, how does she, why are you playing this music?
It's a taste of honey.
I'm just imagining I have to carry a spoonful of honey to Karya, like, can you bring it back?
Yeah.
Like, eat it?
Nope.
Body's still fresh. 3 days.
It's okay.
All right.
Scar.
So you say this to the bride, the possible bride.
That's strange. Oh, so, shall we go find Caria, please?
Yes.
Yes. All right, we're looking for her. Last, I mean.
So out on the cold. Oh, actually, one thing, because we're actually on stage two of Sacred Time right now, which is Hero Quest (parentheses optional). Stage one is worship. So everyone, go ahead and make a worship roll.
Oh, I'm going to adore my sacred bowl seasonally.
All right.
I'm excited. Plants actually change seasons. Yes, it's great.
Yeah. What a concept.
I don't make it.
It's not.
I don't make it either.
Oh my goodness.
Okay.
Am I rolling worship?
Worship. Yes. Well, even on a failure, since this is sacred time, you get 2d6 rune points back.
I got a 2.
All right. So if you succeed, then you get all rune points back, no matter what. You don't have to roll.
Oh, I see. Because it was a shit.
2d6, right?
Yep. If you failed, yeah.
Oh, I guess I would have buffed my shrine up also, just for whatever that's worth.
Yeah. I mean, back. I didn't spend any rune points, so
gems.
Okay, you're good.
I spent a lot, apparently.
How many do you have?
I'm down to 3, is that right?
Oh no, 3 is where you're at. Probably. Oh, that's
okay.
Where you're at, yep.
And we're rolling for...
Well, to regain them if you had spent them, but you didn't.
Uh-huh. Ah, okay, never mind.
And then a God Talker of Marangor gets a bit of spirit magic.
I do.
Yes, you do.
What do I get?
Well,
the fuck do I get?
Yeah.
Let's see. Do you want Befuddle? What do you have right now? You have Blade Sharp.
Blade Sharp, Iron Hand, Heal, and Vigor.
Heal and Vigor. Okay, so we've got Befuddle, Bludgeon, Demoralize, Disrupt, Dull Blade, or Strength.
Befuddle. Okay. Not gonna lie, I was raised in a temple, and yet I'm the one who's taking my commitment the least seriously here.
You left. You were like,
well, you left to find someone, but also experience the world a little bit.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You
know.
I'll commit when I get back.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
You're on a.
You spent your whole freaking life committing.
Yeah.
So.
It's true. It's like true. You're taking a mini vacation.
All right. So Caria, your compatriots find you out near your little menhir.
Yeah.
Okay.
Having recently returned from the spirit world.
Excellent.
And of course their news to you that Hend is dead would come as no surprise.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you
don't react?
Oh yeah, maybe when you come up, as soon as you approach, I say Hend is dead.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh. So powerful. How did you know? And then I think she probably thought because she saw our faces. Maybe that's why.
Oh.
That has to be it.
Yeah.
This is not
for you. So can I anyone? I have an incarnate ancestor. Rune magic spell.
That would be like a new life, right?
Well, that would be to bring up one of your ancestors so you could talk to them.
Okay, yeah, so it wouldn't...
No. However...
Well, would that ancestor know how to raise a body?
Your dad definitely would.
He's
probably
alive,
a hobby.
Though.
Yeah.
What's your dad's name?
Oh, we had it. In here.
Dad.
Yeah.
Bones daddy.
Oh, God. Let's see.
No, that's another pet name.
Carthalo.
Carthalo.
Oh,
does Carthalo know how to raise a body, Caria?
Yes, very likely.
Do you know how to do that?
Do kids want to see a dead body?
Yes. And I want you to see bring them back to life. That's what I want to see.
I don't know if I'm feeling weird about this.
Eli, we must bring him back.
My death is 75. Does that mean I'm like he should remain dead?
No, I don't think necessarily, because death can also mean...
I feel like he's on his journey, like whatever it is, but...
Just let him go, man. He's on his journey.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think probably, I don't know what the spell would be or what
endings.
The process would be, but I...
Yeah.
Denial.
Ruthless.
He would probably have to be willing, right? His spirit would have to be
yes,
willing.
You could at least go and ask him if he wants to come
okay.
back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That, I think
start
that's
with
reasonable.
That.
That's reasonable.
Okay.
Okay.
Great. So I would meditate?
Well, I think Incarnate Ancestor is actually a great option.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. And we can all ask him. All
right.
Excellent. So I'll spend the three...
Three rune points.
All of them.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, wow.
Wait, does that mean she won't have enough to incarnate him if we want to incarnate him?
No, that's what it costs to incarnate him.
Oh, I see.
So,
Yeah, and yeah, how many days of sleep would it take to regenerate that?
It's going to be next season, so
oh, okay.
You'll be tapped out.
You're a good friend.
Yeah.
You're good.
Yeah.
All right.
So we're going to spend that.
Points for you.
And then, yeah, that's right. And then you're going to roll against your death. Wait, is it blank? Let's see, hold on. Rune magic and incarnate ancestor. I just had it. And then it went away. And now it's here again.
Huh?
Man, actually. You're gonna roll
man. Okay. Yeah. Whoa! 16 out of 80.
Oh, wow. Nice. It's a special success.
Yay! Awesome.
I wonder if that does anything for you.
So we're at Karya's and in the temple, and his body just goes, and he's like, why am I awake?
Nope.
No, she's visiting him. She's gonna go have a convo.
No, none of that.
Well, what's going on? Now I'm confused.
Hold on, I'm looking something up here. Roll D100 equal to or less than rune affinity, yes.
It's loading. Yeah, loading.
On a fumble, okay. No special effects for a special. Too bad, but you can check the rune.
Yes.
So. Karya goes into a meditative trance, and...
Do we also have to cover her head?
And she,
Right!
Yeah,
we like, do it anyway!
It's antibacterial, right?
Yeah.
You can... A wind kind of picks up, and it's carrying the smell of damp earth, and...
And me.
Well, we've only just started that tip.
Yeah. Oh, right. Oh, okay. You
should just crawl out of grave.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you smell damp earth can be detected. Mm. And then she sort of stiffens up and then opens her eyes and speaks in somebody else's voice.
Mm. Hey, guys. My Dave impression, sorry.
Oh, no. She has incarnated one of her ancestors.
Yes.
Oh, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Who is it?
It is. One second. Let's see. It is your great 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 grandmother.
Oh wow.
Mm-hmm. And her name is Rastala.
Okay.
So what's she like?
So she says, Who has summoned me from the land of the dead? And what would you know?
Karya summoned you, your relative.
So she kind of looks at her hands.
Yeah.
See.
And we are looking for my cousin, Hend. He's recently passed, and we wanted to speak with him.
He's a great friend of ours. We want to know if he'd like to be resuscitated back to the land of the living.
It is sacred time, is it not?
It is.
Then go to the house of the goddess Arnalda in the city of Clearwine and descend.
That's convenient.
Well, it's a big time temple. Descend beneath the loom house to the cellars underneath and seek out the goddess of death, Tai Kora Tek, and she will lead you into the underworld.
Neat.
And that's the only way to ask him.
You must go and find him yourself.
Got it. My actual reaction is opposite of neat. It's like, oh.
Quite the opposite.
I'm excited. I'm down with goddesses of death.
Like a cat.
Yeah, yes.
Find your friend in the court of silence.
Wait, does that mean he can't speak when we get there?
We'll have to find out.
Yeah, we don't know.
You're learning how to write. It'll be fine.
Yeah, it's all good.
Pleasure rings. Alright, well, thank you for that instruction. It's helpful. Do you require anything before departing?
Do you have any wine?
I'm sure one of us probably has a cast pouch.
Are we supposed to feed wine to dead spirits and shit?
I'm cool. I want to give her a gift for giving us that advice.
But maybe that's
she'll
a bless
you later. Maybe. To us.
You know what?
I probably
she might
have
bless
a wine
you later.
Skin. Exactly.
Yeah.
So I give her some from my wineskin.
I take right, three so steps you, back away.
Yeah. You unsling your wineskin and she sort of licks her lips. Karya licks her lips.
Yeah.
And she says, Could you put some blood in it?
Ooh.
Eli, I'll
go ahead and...
No! Yeah.
Oh, awesome. Yeah.
I cut, like, one of my fingers.
Yeah.
Put drops.
Okay.
I'm putting this out there. I think this is a horrible idea.
And then I give it to her. That's why we play.
So she lifts the wineskin and licks the blood off the, you know, the spout, mm-hmm. and then just drinks
the
heartily.
Whole thing.
About
almost
half of it.
Wow.
And then, yeah, let's fly a great belch.
Yeah.
And then just Karya kind of falls backwards.
That's the first thing she's had to eat in like days.
I know.
Yes.
Real blood sugar spike.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so you blink back into awareness and you're kind of like spread eagled on the ground.
Yeah.
Looking
and
up
like
at the sky.
Really dizzy probably.
Right? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, kind of drunk.
Ooh, I feel drunk.
Karya, what happens when you give wine and blood to a ghost who's possessing you?
Oh, that's a typical death ritual.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
great.
So, yeah, you're good. What happened?
Your great, great, great grandmother says hi.
Oh,
and she gave us instructions on where to go. So we're going to the house of the goddess Ernalda.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Temple there, and go to the Loom House cellars to seek out the goddess of death.
Oh, that sounds excellent.
Yeah. Are you well enough to accompany us?
She's already going. Let's go. Okay.
Squabbling ever since.
How are you?
All right. So off we go.
Yep.
All right. So you return to Clearwine.
Yeah.
Sacred time ceremonies are still underway. Like that. And and so you seek out Intarios the Supporter, the priestess of Ernalda. And she is...
she look like?
Oh, you've met her before, briefly, way back when. But she's a middle-aged woman of somewhat severe aspect, very powerful woman.
Mm-hmm.
Chief priestess of the Earth Temple in Clearwine, so it's one of the biggest temples in the country.
I can dig it.
Yeah. Uh-huh. She effectively has the status of a queen.
Mm-hmm.
Every man she's ever backed has won his battle or quest, ergo her nickname. She is several times widowed.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, I remember her.
And a small army of suitors camps outside the temple.
Can I try to marry her?
Oh.
Maybe.
I want
her
What's her charisma?
What's her cha? I might actually have it. Let's see. So there's this army of suitors outside.
Yeah, it's like, I'm imagining like a cross-section of people.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's all different types of like clans and races and like,
just,
they all want like whatever she has. Like,
yeah.
That power.
I sent Desiree this thing the other day where it was like a fake text exchange and it was like Odysseus is the person who's texting. And it says, Penelope, I'm alive, I'm coming home. And then her response is like, oh my god, I knew it. I knew you weren't dead. I've remained chaste these 20 years, you know, turning away all these suitors. And then, like, the simultaneous timestamp from him, like, I fucked several goddesses. and then she's like, what? And he's like, sorry, autocorrect. I missed you too.
Oh my god. She just opens the door. All y'all get in here.
Yeah, pretty much. All right, so her chaw is a...
Calypso, I mean, what?
Yeah, right.
What is that all?
Her chaw is a mean 15.
Oh, I can be 15 when my cats buff me.
15, yes. Wow.
But what is she looking for, like, in a mate?
Mm-hmm.
Good question. These suitors would certainly like to know, and they don't want anyone else bothering her, so they...
you know what? They can just fuck off.
They sort of block the path into the temple complex.
I move them.
No, yeah, Kava.
I will roll to move them.
So,
I'm gigantic.
I know. So they're like, hold on, no storm bowl worshiper is going to sully the grounds of this earth temple. You can be off.
We're the priestesses.
Excuse me, I'm here on a holy quest. Not conquest. I'm here on a holy quest, and we need to speak with her. It is of the utmost importance.
All right,
can I roll my
earth?
And if you don't get out of my way, I'll just move you.
You know.
What you can do is roll your earth rune to buff her skill roll that she's about to
that
make.
That we're like doing the holy quest.
Yeah, yes, exactly.
Yes,
yeah.
Which one should I roll? Just strength?
Intimidate or aid, your choice.
Yeah, it's mostly just like you're not immediately doing it. Yet.
Okay, so you're gonna get a plus 20.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, that's a
16.
Nope.
All right.
Can I just move them though?
You can get physical if you want. Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna let Eli chime in.
I don't mind talking.
Like, no, but seriously, guys.
Yeah. No, really.
All right. So give Eli one chance.
No. Like I bring my arms up to just like.
And yeah. Like you're starting to.
Wait.
Yeah. Eli jumps in front of you.
Eli jumps.
Oh.
Yeah.
So I'm just come on now, like guys.
Yeah,
wait, Bruce your neck. You know,
like, so does my standing there like this, arms raised, help buff his ability to talk to them?
Ooh, you could roll your intimidate to give him a bonus.
Please, please.
Yeah.
Please.
Don't fumble. I didn't fumble. I actually made. I have a really low intimidate, but I actually
made it.
Thank God.
Great. All right. So okay. +20 to your.
To what should I do?
Well, orate. Yeah.
Edie orates.
Yeah, Edie's like, I can help.
No.
Maybe you should. Alright,
so +20 to my orate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
I believe in you.
Should I. Okay, I'm just gonna roll it first.
Okay.
I make it. Oh my gosh. Okay, thank God. Okay.
Was it like a 30?
No, it was a 40. It was buffed to 40. I have 20 usually.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
So I said, oh, okay, we are here on a quest. My cousin has died and we need to speak with the goddess. We have no claim over your courtship of the priestess.
Creeps.
All right, so they're kind of like, well, considering the time, all right, fine.
Get out of the way. I love that, and they're like trying to woo this like priestess. They're effectively like stopping up like just the daily.
Like
a temple, protocol, like, why they're there.
Yeah.
Also,
okay. I'm Toad's gonna hit on her. Bye.
Bye.
Using the cuttlefish method.
That's right.
So,
all right. So you pass through the goddess arch.
Wow, beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And which is trellised with vines, which of course this year are bare.
Yes.
Or this time of year are bare.
Yes.
And two goddess statues on either side.
All right.
And you walk into the temple complex, which has several buildings, of course, but the main one is the Copper House. Also known as the Loom House.
Yes, this is where we need to go.
It's known as the Copper House because it is faced entirely with copper panels, which are shiny. Hammered into various reliefs. Actually, not shiny, green.
They have a patina.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so, Antarios is outside. She's talking with a couple of the axe maidens of Barbeester Gore who guard the temple.
Cool! Yeah, but you'd like that, huh?
I do. I have my cat buff me, my cha.
Oh, okay. Sure.
Although, is there going to be a problem with this since you just became an initiate of some other cult?
Yeah, this
cult?
Is kind
of
bad.
Doesn't
mean I can't like another human being. I just can't worship.
Yeah.
No, but is she going to have like personal qualms with that?
Right.
It does make it a little more intensive. Yes.
Not as genuine.
Well.
Or.
It brings up some politics.
Is there a conflict? Because I thought the thing you read said any friendly cults are fine. Is this cult friendly?
Friendly? Oh, that's a good question.
Stormbowl
is kind of barely tolerated in general.
I'm a
like,
for instance, anyway.
My cult of Aretha is his mother, for
you
instance.
Would be,
and so that could be.
Yep.
Or
Maren Gore is the daughter.
So does that mean I cannot hit on her?
You could, I'm just saying your chances aren't going to be great. So
they might be lowered.
Maybe I'll woo her anyway. I'm going to try it anyway.
Woo!
Buffed.
So, she sees you all coming in. She's, of course, a bit surprised by this.
No one's been to visit the temple in months.
Right. and so she walks over towards you and says, yes, what can I do for all of you? Karya, yes, hello.
Hello.
What is going on?
Well, we have a friend who has just recently died, and we...
Hens, right?
Yes! What? Yes.
Well, his body was bought here.
Oh, yeah.
His body was brought here.
Bought and brought.
Yes.
Yes,
he passed away.
They purchased his body.
And,
honey, though.
And I suppose you, want to go and fetch him back.
Well, we will ask him first if that's something that he would want.
But yes, ostensibly.
Yeah.
This is a propitious time.
Can I hand her a flower? Oh my god.
This is a propitious time. Oh, what?
You know what they say, never hit on a lady while she's at work.
That's for right. You, lady.
Oh my god.
All right, so she Yes. Thank you. All right, so what you can do...
Where'd the flower come from? It's sacred time, so things are more...
Well, this is the Earth Goddess Temple. In fact, I was even thinking maybe those vines...
were actually in bloom?
Well, not in bloom, but they probably already have some grapes growing on them, even though it's, you know...
Whoa. Yeah, I picked it along the way. This was my plan, was to hit on it.
All right. Okay.
Your earrings are glinting off your neck, and I thought you had, like, two Band-Aids on your neck, like you just got bit by a vampire or something.
I like that that's where your mind first goes, though.
It looked like
I know, you have a boo-boo, you got bit by a vampire.
Don't take them off.
No, they look great.
No, they look great. The gold is nice.
Bring them on. They're pretty.
He's saying he had an optical illusion.
It was an optical illusion.
Focus on the story, please.
Thank you. All right, it was just very alarming. It's so like, why? I'm like, has she had those Band-Aids on this whole time? Oh, God, I didn't notice. I'm horrible.
That's true. It hasn't been the first. That would be the first or last time you're like, when did that happen? Like,
Anyway, so go ahead and roll your charisma times.
You two are so cute.
Mine? I just.
Aww.
Thank you. We try.
So my current charisma, right?
You buffed charisma times two, yes.
Ooh.
That's pretty big.
Not really.
Oh.
It's bigger than what...
I do not make it.
Aww. So she just says, thank you. And then she just kind of sticks it in her hair a little absentmindedly.
I put things in my hair too. Observe the bones.
We have so much in common.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Most awkward date ever.
This is awkward.
So
you're a fan of death, you say.
Yes, exactly.
So she says come within the temple. I will summon my priestesses.
We were told to go to the Loomhouse cellars.
So she kind of eyes you a little narrowly and says, "Yes, that is where you should go."
And we're supposed to seek out the goddess of death, Tycora Tech.
Come with me.
I like that she's kind of like, "This is my job, so if you could just let me."
Again, Eunuch explaining.
It's like when you Eunuch explaining.
I love that I have a mouth as slave.
It's like when you try to talk to a doctor about your health, and it's like, yeah. I don't know. I mean, I think it might be
an infection. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Anyway.
But I looked it up.
On WebMD.
Yeah, I found it on WebMD.
It's definitely brewing.
So over the next.
Definitely brew
AIDS. Over the next hour or so, you are all kitted out.
Ooh.
So one of you is going to be playing the role of Ernalda. So who wants to be that person?
I have super high fertility, yo.
Yeah, go for it.
Probably a good idea.
Ooh.
So
you guys are all into death. No,
I'm definitely into death. My death is 75, man.
Puik, you are wrapped in a funeral shroud.
Mm-hmm.
And it is done in a way like as if you were an actual goddess who had died. So there's incense being burnt and chants being chanted.
I've probably seen this before.
Oh yeah, that's true actually. Where you're from? Yeah.
We're all like, oh my god, please say, ah, fuck it, this is
normal. No. I mean, still fancy.
Still delighted.
Yeah.
I'm sure they like prepare your body.
Yes,
like,
you're anointed. You're anointed
like,
with oils
and flowers and jewelry.
And then wrapped in a shroud.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The rest of you are given sort of funereal clothing to don.
Random tunics.
Yeah. just black tunics.
Smells like the last.
Also.
Yeah.
Also. Also horns and cymbals.
Okay.
You know? All
right.
Oh.
And so.
Wait,
and
are we talking horns and cymbals like musical instruments?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, I
not
totally
horns
thought horns
and cymbals.
No.
I was about to ask, do any of them conflict with the cymbals I already have?
No.
So your job is to be the funereal procession. You are to mourn and cry and clash their instruments and toot your
Make
horns.
Make it more convincing.
This exactly.
This is difficult for me because I am devastated about him being.
Yeah, I am actually really upset he's dead.
Mm. So you are told by the priestesses and the god talkers that you must carry Ernalda, quote unquote, to the cellars of the Loom House.
Okay. We do so.
Okay.
Yep.
So, you are sort of sent off with the chanting of the priestesses as you descend down a set of stone stairs that wend around a little bit as you're all kind of you're like sort of the pallbearers for Puig as Ernalda.
Mm-hmm.
And so you carry her body down to the cellars.
Small. Yeah. It's actually a relief.
It's not Kaba that we pressed.
Yeah.
That would have been a shot.
A little yeah. Oh, the hernia. A wheelbarrow. Come
on. And as you descend into the cellars, you feel this cold wind blowing, and you can see kind of out of the shadows of the cellar, which is lit by oil lamps and whatnot. Yeah. You can see these shapes stepping out of the shadows.
Ooh, yeah. That's really creepy.
And so out of the darkness at the far end of the cellar. A figure riding upon the back of a wolf emerges.
I love it.
Do we know if that's what's her butt? Well, I mean, would we recognize her if we saw her? Tech, call, to whatever.
Tai Kora Tech.
That's let's see. Actually, I think, Karya, you would recognize him.
Oh, okay.
This is Nontria, the Taker and Waster.
Okay.
He's bloated. His mm-hmm. skin is dark black. Mm. A blood-red tongue lolls out of his gaping, fanged mouth.
Ooh.
And he wears a garland of skulls and corpses and a blood-stained burial shroud.
How big is he?
Fairly massive.
Oh my I know, it's God. Like actually, like, little corpses, like, beads.
Corpses are, like, his, yeah, they're, like, little pendants.
Is he, like, Kali, yeah. but kind of grosser and
uh-huh, mouth? Yeah.
He's a dude, so naturally he's a person.
He has a pair of trident-shaped daggers tucked in his belt.
Oh my gosh.
And he says, he speaks,
oh.
and he says, "Ere you have brought me Arnalda, I will take her as my wife."
Gross.
Oh,
nasty.
Yeah, thank you.
What?
At this point you see Puik in her shroud looks dead.
Oh, no.
She is pale. She is cold to the touch.
Wait, were we given like a tutorial on how this was supposed to go? Why weren't we?
Yeah. Uh-oh, Karya.
It's okay, everybody chill out.
This is going exactly according to plan.
Yeah, all you right. guys are holding on to this world a little too tightly.
Well, what do we do?
Alright, so I mean, so he says he wants to take her as his wife.
Mm-hmm.
So do we just...
So he dismounts from his horned wolf.
Oh, wow.
What?
And sort of, you know, waddles over under his great girth.
Oh, man.
And takes out one of his daggers and uses the tip to sort of pull back the burial shroud.
Oh.
And gets in really close, looking at Puik like...
Mm. That might be a little too fresh for him.
So,
yeah, I know.
You have to fool him.
Okay.
Oh.
So, you're going to roll against your choice of earth, fertility, or harmony.
Oh.
We're gonna go fertility because I was 75.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm. Harmony is a close second, though, to 70.
Mm. All right.
Yeah.
Can you?
I got a 2.
Yay!
Check that rune.
Yeah.
And,
But bam.
Is that a super success or just a special
success?
That is
that's a critical, I think.
Yeah, that is
critical. For the 75?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
He's so full.
She's got everyone dead in himself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because 2% of 75 is 1.5, which is round up to 2. So yeah. Sheesh. All right, so...
Nice. Thanks, Dice.
All right, so... So he looks her over, and then he just... turns around and gets back on his wolf and just slowly lopes off, and all the dead shades who are observing you kind of recede into the shadows.
Mm.
And so now you can see that you can see the walls of the cellar now in light of the oil lamps. And there are these murals, very colorful murals. And the biggest one, which is from the wall that he appeared from,
mm-hmm.
Is a gaunt, skull-faced woman wrapped tightly in a black shroud, mm-hmm. and you recognize that as Tai Kora Tech.
Okay,
there she is.
And suddenly, the image on the mural steps out Ooh. From the wall.
Oh,
excellent. I scream!
Oh God!
Oh shit!
Just was surprised.
How big is she? Is she like?
She's like your size. Okay. Yeah. So she pulls back her shroud, Ooh. And you see that she's not just gone. She's actually skeletal.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So she's like an actual skull.
Yeah.
But like, you know, 80s Spielberg film skeleton with like the hair still clinging to the scalp, you know.
I love it.
That's cool. Yeah. I whisper, guys, if things go tits up, I'm putting her head on my shrine wall.
Oh my god.
You're talking about a goddess.
You can't hear me yet.
So she walks across the cellar and she walks to Puik.
Okay.
And leans down and says, she sleeps. She is not dead. And at once you shudder awake, screaming out the secret words of life.
Whoa! Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
Which are butternut squash.
Jesus Christ.
Why every time?
And then she gestures to you all and says, follow me. Follow me to Havanvor and beyond.
Yeah.
Okay, Kari's like,
get out of the way!
Hey, hey!
Me first, me first.
We can come back, like, intact, right? Just to be clear.
We'll see.
Yeah.
It's more exciting this way.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to know.
Guys, I'm a little nervous.
I don't want to know.
I have things to plant. I mean, I'm just...
You're like kind of muttering as you walk through the wall.
So as you're saying that, like, you're the one who wanted to resurrect Hen.
We're doing this because you said you want to resurrect Hen.
I don't want to walk through the Valley of the Dead. I want to plant some saplings and have someone else bring them.
Well, then you should have. I mean... You should have thought about that.
Your death is super hot. I feel like you're totally fine with this.
Yeah. Come on. Alright, so we're following the goddess.
So, she takes you back towards the mural and then just walks through the wall and you all follow her through the wall.
That's weird.
This is part of the hero's journey, you guys.
Yeah.
Guys, any of you read Joseph Campbell? Come on. Come on. Come on.
I'm assigning it all to you.
Okay. Alright, so you're now, you find yourselves walking through a realm with no sun, no stars, no planets.
Oh, wow.
There's no sky, just a vast empty blackness. The air is stagnant and poisonous. The ground is broken and treacherous. Jagged mountains that look like obsidian flints just planted in the earth stick up on the horizon. Endless swamps stretch off in different directions. Pits can be seen here and there. And so you follow your guide across the bleak and dismal landscape of the underworld. You travel over sharp ridges and past great gorges. And you see many strange and disturbing sights as you walk. Huge moving shadows wandering across the land, filling you with dread and fear. Tyakora Tech says, those are the ancient powers of darkness called Dehori. They destroy lesser beings with fear.
Do I know what those are? Are they chaos related?
No. You see a range of immense giants the size of mountains buried chest deep. They rage, cry, plead, curse, and beg at all they see. Mm. Those are some of the giants defeated by Orlanth and cast down into the underworld, the goddess tells you. Mm. You hear the sound of 10,000 drums of all sorts. This alerts you to a huge host of tens of thousands of trolls and darkness demons assembled in a deep valley below you. Tyakora Tech says, that is but part of the army of darkness that gathers to invade the Middle World when the Hero Wars erupt.
When will they erupt?
Oh, they're erupting.
That's what she says?
You've heard prophecies.
Spoiler alert.
Prophecies of doom.
Oh, right.
I'll kill them all with fire.
The path skirts the edge of an immense and foreboding dead forest. It is shadowy and gloomy within bowshot of its outer edge. To penetrate further is to leave behind almost all light. Patches of fog drift about. Odd lights appear and disappear. That is Nightwood, a place as timeless as the dark or the forests. Mm. And as you are following your guide past Nightwood, you hear barks and blood-curdling howls of a large pack of dogs or wolves, and even more terrifying shouts and cries. Mm. And you see wolves come pouring out of the woods towards you.
Shit.
They're backed by fierce winds that sting like red-hot hail. Mm. You see amongst them a rider riding upon an eight-legged horse with a eagle's beak for a head.
Okay.
That's definitely cooler than normal horses.
Yeah.
Spider horse.
And you recognize the rider, actually. He is headless, but he carries his head in his hand. And You recognize him as Danikos of the Grey Dog Clan.
Oh.
He whom you slayed in the Broken Tower.
That's right.
Oh, good. What could come on?
So we found a new job. Huh?
He sounds like he got a promotion.
Much better, buddy.
Yeah.
Bygones and all so that.
Maybe he is armed with a long barbed spear.
Uh-oh.
And he comes charging towards you as the wolves spread out and surround you.
Wow.
And
don't fear, don't fear.
And he pulls up and he says, "You." And he's pointing his spear directly at Kaba.
Fuck you, bro. I had it coming. Yeah. I've already got my thing, my big bladey thing.
Come at me,
bro.
All right.
Ask, what do you want, Danikos?
I want your soul.
Well, fuck you, man. I'm using it.
I'm using it right now.
I want to ask, what's her face? Do we have to engage with Do we have to engage with beings from this realm, or are we protected from having to engage with them?
She kind of laughs, this sort of clattering laugh. She says, "You have no protection here."
Okay.
Oh, shit, mom.
Let's cut a rug then.
Question for Karya.
I'm gonna hate having to kill this guy twice.
Do you still have the stone with the spirit?
Yes, I do.
Yes.
Now I've been shining it, polishing it.
You can feel it vibrating in your pack or wherever it is you carry.
Oh yeah, yeah. Now it's at my belt.
Okay. Yeah. You can feel it like kind of almost humming.
Oh, excellent. So I'll reach in and I'll grab it some more.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes.
Yes.
Actually, it's very cold.
Oh, really? Okay.
Like ice cold. Yeah.
And
revenge is a dish best served.
That's right. Wow. Mm-hmm. So I take it out and I hold it out in my palm.
Okay. So, so the ghost of, let's see here, Lanaki, right?
Yeah, remember Lanaki, her? Yes.
Yeah.
Rises up out of the stone.
Oh, I love it. Yes.
Sees Danikos.
And she's mad.
And his severed head, which he's cradling in his arms, gets this look of shock.
Yeah!
and says, "Lanaki!" And then just reins the horse around and goes charging off back into the woods, and she just takes off after.
Oh, no! She's gonna get her revenge!
You friggin' coward!
Yeah, totally. Well, that was
beautiful.
That was good.
Yeah!
Does she seem amused?
No, she was furious.
No.
The god of Tekra Tech.
Oh, she's a skull, so.
She smiles.
Right.
She might be away.
Her jaw starts clattering happily. No, she just watches it all very impassively.
Yeah.
Just curious.
Yeah, me too. I was wondering if she was...
She's seen a lot.
The wolves all follow?
Yes, they do.
Okay.
So, you continue on.
Doopy-doo.
You keep walking for a time before you see a river of people, basically, walking. Men, women, children, ducks, brew, all manner of creatures.
Octopuses? There are no chaos creatures.
Well, brew are chaos creatures.
Well, then, there are octopuses?
I suppose.
Octopi.
All kinds of creatures. You see, old people, young people. Girls with their tender hearts freshly scarred by sorrow. Great armies of battle dead, stabbed by bronze spears. Men of war still wrapped in bloody armor.
Wow.
Sartorites, Lunars, Praxians, Azrolians, Grazers. Men and women of every nation. Some are kings and thanes born by noble steeds. Mm. Others are naked or wear mere scraps of cloth.
Mm.
Some are just skeletons. Others are fully intact.
Wow.
All bear the markings of their life and death.
Huh.
Trolls. That's another one.
Trolls.
Yes, so all are united in death and silence, for none speak or quarrel.
Oh, this is the silence place. This is where we're supposed to go.
Court of silence.
Yeah.
So they're all walking in one direction. And yes, sure enough, Tyakor Tech kind of leads you into that procession, and you just start walking with them.
Great.
So we're looking for Hend.
Mm-hmm. So you just keep on walking. You all think of a song that sings of mortality and how one day all will walk the path of silence. know from where you came and where you are going, from where you came, from a putrid drop, from where you are going to a place of dust, maggots, and worms. Ugh. And, yeah, so as you walk, you can feel your kind of connection to the world of the living weakening.
Uh-oh, that's not good.
If we are already high in death, does that affect that process at all?
Well, what you can do is think of something that would connect you to the world
of the living. To the world of the living.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to connect with the movement.
Okay, so yeah.
I could think of my shrine of skull heads, but that's no good.
No.
So, well, I was just going to say.
Earth. I also have earth. I have a strong earth connection, too.
That could work.
So I'm going to connect with earth, actually.
And actually, rolling against death could work just because it's reminding yourself that you're not dead.
Okay.
Right? True. Mm. So we can just roll against it right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'm rolling against earth.
I'm thinking of the sun, so I'm going to roll my fire.
And make it.
Oh, okay.
So I'm just thinking about, like, the soil and the, mm-hmm. the ground, like, literally the ground.
Yeah.
And, like, living things starting to come out of the ground now. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But that's the time of year it is.
Okay.
Kari is thinking of her role as a guide
mm-hmm.
For the dead.
Yes.
To the spirit realm, and that's a pretty important job to have.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Made it?
Yep.
Okay. And
made it. I made it. I did roll for death. I think she's sitting there thinking about, I can't die yet. It's not my time. I have things to do. Places to conquer.
Have a giant to plant. A giant to bang.
Butternut squash to consider.
Oh my. So you travel the path of silence for a seemingly endless amount of time on a plane of black ash.
Uh-huh.
You cannot tell if it's been 10 hours or 10 days or even 10 years.
Wow.
Here the underworld is silent without weather and without any change in the gray darkness. Suddenly, you are startled by an incredible din of crashing metal on metal.
Uh-oh.
You see a deep gorge and a river running through it, but the river is made entirely of swords.
Oh.
Oof.
There is a bridge crossing the gorge. Upon the bridge is a giant, a skeletal giant, actually.
No doll.
he has a immense bone staff in his hand.
Wow.
As the dead file by the skeleton, it ignores many of them, but others it knocks off the bridge with its bone staff into the chasm below.
Oh, shit.
What is your favorite color?
Ty Koratek explains, the giant is Janak, a gatekeeper of the underworld. He is charged with keeping perjurers, oathbreakers, and those who violate hospitality from crossing the bridge.
Oathbreakers. So this is where your giant's gonna end up, man.
Yeah,
no, this is where Hend is gonna end up. Well, yeah.
Getting knocked into a river of swords.
Well, there's that too, but... Alright, then.
So, we came all the way down here just to find out he's already mincemeat, literal mincemeat. I'm gonna be.
So, are we looking for Hend? I mean, we're looking for him in the line of people.
At least he's already dead.
Yeah.
That is true.
We're looking for him.
So, you see him just up ahead, just kind of, you know, walking forward, very mechanically walking towards the skeleton. And he's not quite there yet.
Okay, so I'm gonna run. I'm gonna run toward him.
Yeah.
All right, so you catch up with him, you grab hold of his shoulder, and he just kind of looks at you very blankly.
Yeah.
You know, like, he just
doesn't recognize us.
Yeah.
So we can't talk to him? Mm. Karya, can you can you something? Anything?
And!
you just smack him.
I speak spirit.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yep.
Yeah?
You
all
do?
Right.
But not very well.
Give that a shot. Well, you can try and buff it with a death rune, for example.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I have to roll death rune?
Yep.
First, and then, 29 out of 75.
75, okay.
So plus 20.
Plus 20.
Let's see, spirit.
Oh,
I rolled a...
06.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay, great.
Yay.
Is that a special? What's your modified skill?
Oh, modified, it is 57.
57, so yeah, that is a special.
That is.
Yay.
Yeah. All right, so he just looks at you all, and there seems to be a little bit of recognition, and then he says, do you have anything to drink?
Sure. Where's that wine?
I have some.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. I give it to him.
With blood or without?
With.
Okay.
Still has my blood.
You remember the ritual?
Yeah.
Well.
Why are you so proud?
The only downside to doing
Good
that
job.
Is that you're in the middle of a river of dead.
Yeah.
So as soon as you
all come running. Yeah, yeah. This is book 10 of the Odyssey.
Eli doesn't have to cut himself because we still have the wine that already has the blood in it.
Yeah.
Mm. So it's not like you have to cut yourself.
No,
no, but just the smell of it.
The smell, I'll be able to smell it.
Mm-hmm. All right, so
I hand it to him.
Mm-hmm. All right, so they're pressing in.
Hend, do you want to live or do you want to remain
chug,
here?
Chug.
So yeah, so he takes a quaff and he says, yes, I want to live.
Yeah, I know it.
Now the dead are pressing in on you, all these hands and everything, and it's kind of pushing you off to the side.
Wait, I know. Throw the fucking wineskin, and then I'll go for the wineskin.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
We'll do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really. So
yeah, I'm gonna throw it.
Okay.
Throw it.
All right. So you throw it, and that of course does the trick. It gets them running in the opposite direction after it.
Okay.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
So are we gonna have enough time to get back to the land of the living and resurrect him before he gets to the bridge pass to like get past the gatekeeper? Like, or can he just
don't we just take his spirit with us?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we do. We retrieve it that way. Okay. Yeah. All right. I was confused.
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
We'll see once we get to the portal. All
right.
And this is a thing, right? Like, no one's going to be mad at us that we're, like, K-Talk Tick, whatever her name isn't going to be mad.
No.
Ty Cora Tech.
I'm not good at names.
That's why I wrote it down. Neither am I.
It sounds like it's fairly common.
Yeah.
At least, so let's pull him away. Uncommon.
Mm-hmm.
So let's usher. Can we usher him away?
Yes, you can.
Go against the river?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And so you do.
With people.
Yeah. And so you do. You get away from the path of silence.
Yes.
And you return. Tycora Tech guides you back to when she came, which was good because even though it feels like you're going back the exact same path, all the features are different.
It's all different.
Yeah.
Oh God.
And so you do end up back at the cellar of the Loom House.
Okay.
And Caria, you have Hen's spirit sort of bound to you.
Okay, great.
And so you bring that with you out of the cellar to the casket, place it back in the body, and then at this point he rises up out of the honey. You know,
when he suffocated by honey, like it's freak. When we want to wipe off his face first before.
I want to taste the honey.
I don't want to taste cadaverous honey.
I do. The stuff on top has technically not.
Brew some mead out of it. That would be some powerful stuff.
Oh my god, corpse mead.
Yeah.
So he rises.
He rises. So he brought Hend back from the dead.
Oh, yay. Wow. Is he happy about this?
He's very happy about it because I did all this without consulting Dave about it. So. When you guys are like, I don't know, I'm like, oh.
That's what you imagine listening to it going, wait, what?
Yeah. I'm sorry, what happened?
Uh-oh.
Oh, so we bring him back to life. Do his wounds automatically heal, or are they just these gaping, like...
His wounds do heal, yes.
Wow. All right.
Or if they don't heal on their own, there's plenty of priests and priestesses around to heal for him.
And you're back! I hug him. I was so worried.
It's a sticky hug.
Sticky hug.
I don't mind. I can bathe.
unlike some people.
Hey!
So I pat him on the shoulder and I say, you know you're late for your wedding. So that's if you still want to get married.
Oh yeah.
So he does.
Oh,
and,
wow.
Wait, she still marries him after what I said to her?
She just wrote it off as a Storm Bowl initiate being an asshole.
These
fucking
people. No wonder I don't like people.
Uh-oh.
No wonder you live out in a cabin in the middle of nowhere.
I do.
With a skull garden.
Yeah. Oh my god, that's what I'll do next is a garden of skulls. Oh, I'm going to start planting it now.
I'm just imagining like you've got like the strawberry planter, but it's like growing out of the eyes and the top of the head.
Oh, yeah. Or like a chia pet.
Maybe like a Zen garden, only instead of like the rocks that are amongst the swirls, it's actually just giant skulls that I've collected.
Different times.
Alright, so you all get plus 1d6 reputation for doing that.
Alright, so we're back at the wedding, I guess, a couple days later.
It's that day. But,
is it a happy occasion now?
It's a happy occasion, for sure.
Yay!
And,
Wow, that was pretty great.
Yeah, that was the hero quest portion.
Yeah.
Now, the remainder of Sacred Time, we can probably blitz through. I know Sage and Penna got to jump out of here. So if you want to leave, that's cool. If you need to leave, that's cool.
What do we need to do?
All right, so first of all, you're going to find out how the harvest was. So we'll just very quickly move through this. The omens last year were ill-favored. That's minus 10%. There was some light raiding from the Grey Dog Clan, so that's a minus 20 total. And then I'm going to roll and see how the harvest is this year. I rolled a 96.
Ooh,
would have normally been superlative, but with a minus 30, it's merely excellent.
Oh, okay.
So that's going to modify your income for this year.
Okay. Wait, do I earn income as a slave?
You do, because you can sell your pelts or whatever you hunt and that kind of thing. So, All right, so let's see here. We'll go around for.
Bridget means I don't have to buy shit for you.
That's
so
true.
Yes.
Why don't we just do Kaba's rolls first?
Oh yes, let's do Kaba's rolls first. All right, so Kaba, you're gonna roll your occupational skill, which as a warrior is battle. So you're gonna roll battle and see how you do.
Okay. Oh no, I don't make it.
You don't make it, so that's a failure. Okay, so you receive only half your base income.
I don't think any of us ever figured out base income.
No.
Really?
Nope.
Yeah, I think we kept
asking. Oh, I've got it here. Don't worry, I've got it here.
Okay, good.
Actually, wait a minute, though. Did you fail if you had a plus 30 to your battle?
I did not fail with a plus 30.
Then you're okay. All right, so you actually receive your base income.
Which
is 60 lunars.
Great.
Is that the same for everyone? Probably not, right? Okay.
All right, so for Hunter, go ahead and roll either track or animal lore with a plus 30.
I don't make it.
So that's half, so you get 25 lunars.
Okay.
A healer, you're going to roll alchemy, first aid, plant lore, or treat disease.
Is Kaba all done, or am I rolling something else at some point?
You're not going to roll anything else, so you can start putting your dice there.
Okay. I'll make it.
Okay, so you receive your regular income, which is 80.
Nice.
Nice.
And then an assistant shaman, which is what you were this year.
Ah, okay.
You're going to roll spirit combat or spirit travel.
Combat, of course.
And with a plus 30.
Plus 30, so that would be 130.
130.
Wow. Okay.
It's funny.
I know.
Ooh, 16.
Okay.
That's a special success. So you receive half again your base income.
Nice.
So that your base income is 20, so you would get 30.
30.
Okay.
Wow, shamans do not make a lot of money.
No.
They're in it for the,
the love.
The love.
Yeah.
The
love. And that wasn't
in it for the death.
An assistant shaman. So full shaman would be what?
I don't know. It's not on this chart, actually. I'll have to look it up.
Okay.
Okay, so now you have to pay for your standard of living. If you're maintaining yourself at free level, that costs 60 lunars. Noble level is 200 lunars. Poor is 15. Obviously, Queek, you'll have to pay for Eli. So.
Wait, so it's free was what?
60.
Well, there goes
all the
money I just made.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, okay, so 60, and then it was 15.
15, so 75. All right. Yeah.
And I'm poor, I think.
So 15.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. However, does Puik have the manage household skill?
Yes.
Okay, you can roll against that to generate some income out of Eli.
Hey, wait a minute. Can I, empower that with anything?
No, these are just
straight
rolls.
Hate
Eli.
Just
curious.
Okay.
I made it with the one!
Yeah! Oh my god!
Hate Eli.
Just because I only have a 20.
Oh my god.
I'm a busy boy.
All the things.
Running
wow.
all over the place.
Okay, so let's see.
That was great.
That's the highest basing. Okay, so yeah, so with a critical, you would get double the base income of a hunter.
Wow,
so that
100?
That is 100, yeah.
Okay.
You made a lot of money off of him.
He's for himself.
All right, everyone ages up by a year.
Oh, good.
Okay.
Anyone who gets married, of course.
Married.
That would be Hend.
Kaba?
Do you want to marry Big Club?
Oh my god, he's not even here!
All right, fine.
You I'm can, sure he wouldn't mind.
You can summon him.
Summon Big
Club. What do I have, a whistle from Giants?
The cat.
No, what you do is I'd lend you some dice so that you could roll charisma times 5 and you'd find out. If you made the roll, then you could marry him.
I'd like to see some courtship first.
All right.
And some actual discussion about whether or not it will kill me to have sex with him.
Fair enough. Fair enough. With
enough lube, anything's possible. But the birth part, though.
All right. Anyone have sex this year?
Yes. Probably.
Well,
I bet
penetrative or
non-penetrative?
This is a childbirth roll. So,
I have a fertility of 75.
Yeah.
And fertility rune is.
And no doubt all the Orlanthi are going to like,
fertility,
hello,
life,
hello.
Sex, birth, giving, and pleasure.
Yeah.
Yeah, go for it.
All right, make a D100 roll. Mm-hmm. You can empower this one with the fertility rune if you want.
I mean, would empowering it make it more likely or less likely?
More likely that you'd have kids.
Nah. I'm, well,
It's not a great time right now.
Just really busy.
Now,
you do get rep for having children.
I have 75.
I feel like I have to.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Empowering it. I got... Ooh, I missed it by one.
Well, there you go. Aww. So this will just be an unmodified roll then.
So we never... Oh, no. Go ahead. I got 20.
Oh. No children.
Aww.
Now I'm disappointed. So we never discussed it specifically, but I did mention that I stayed up drinking and flirting with both the guy at the bar and mortality at one point. So
true. If you want to roll
it up. Roll it up.
I mean, you can't bring it up in the not
one. Yeah, no, you have to roll it.
You can't bring it up in the
naked one.
Exactly.
What
am I rolling? Just
you're just D100.
D100. 81.
You have a child.
Do you know if it's mortalities or the barkeep?
Yeah. Well, if it comes out wearing black face
paint. Who is the father?
All right, so
mortality, you are not the father.
Roll a D6. To see who's dad.
Aw.
Not to see who's the dad.
Yeah, I was like, how are you going to find that out?
I thought that is what I'm rolling
for. No, it's for
the sex of the child.
I guess Kaba would be.
Oh, man. Huge.
That's why she's so emotional and cray-cray.
You know what?
I'm a berserker is why. A four.
So that's a son?
Berserker?
You have a son.
Mm-hmm. You have to name him and everything.
A son.
Can I send him away to train at a Stormbolt Temple so that
he's a baby?
Not as a baby, but he's yes, baby. Eventually. Also, but let's find out if he dies first. Roll D100.
Yeah, come on.
I'll never have children again.
Roll the
shadow.
Yeah, we'll just go off.
Okay.
Oh my god. Oh my. I would never, ever. No.
93?
Not really?
Yeah.
Is that what that is?
I think so.
Oh, you're correct.
It's okay, child lives.
Oh my god.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
And then the last thing is family events. So we'll do Kaba first and then Sage can leave.
Okay.
So roll D100.
What happened?
I don't want to leave. I love you all.
I know, we know.
The hell are you?
88. Crazy
88. 88.
No event for Kaba.
Oh, boom.
No event. Well, hello, I had a son. I think that's enough.
That's pretty eventful.
Wait, I need to know who the dad is, dude.
76. Mortality, you are the father.
That would be a whole other thing.
All right.
That would be a whole other thing.
76. Get an email.
No event.
God damn.
There's only a 15% chance of that.
91.
Scandal of the family.
Yes. Ooh, scandal.
So you're gonna roll. You're gonna roll D100 for the family member, and then D100 for the scandal.
78.
So the family member is a maternal aunt.
Oh no! Actually, no wait. Yeah, because I totally rolled all of that.
Oh, you did. Yeah.
I have 4 aunts.
Oh wow. Okay.
Ooh.
An 86.
Scandal is a messy love affair.
Oh. Ooh.
She's a messy bitch who loves for drama.
Yes.
Pretty messy for Praxians to care, I think.
Yeah, no kidding, right?
It would have to be pretty outrageous.
Like, no wonder I heard about it from
him. He's a brew and I love him.
Oh! He rides a horse.
Oh! Yes.
Gross.
Yes, it's one of the horse riding guys. Either that or one of the domesticated humans that gets herded around by the Mora camp.
Yeah.
I saw an illustration for that.
Yeah.
It's like a little taper dude.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Like his human, like,
and the human's like eating grass. Yeah.
That was adorable. I was like, I want to play one of those guys.
So, yeah. Renee, you rolled an 11, I see?
Yes.
Okay, that is a marriage in the family.
What?
So, roll to see who got married.
Did your dad get married?
Oh, that would be funny. 77, please be my dad.
No, also maternal aunt.
Oh, okay.
What?
Got married.
All right, everyone, that was Sacred Time.
Yay!
And that was a lot of fun, and that was RuneQuest too. We're gonna be taking a break.
Did you decide on what you want to run?
I have not actually. I'm gonna put out a poll on the Patreon to see what people are interested in, and also probably send an email out to you guys as well.
I am really into the idea of playing Morville with Glove. I really liked it a lot.
I thought
it was kind of fabulous.
It's fantastico.
That has to be one of my top favorite moments. You pulling your Lady Day's blood out and just smacking that fucking Chola bitch.
Yeah. Only in Velvet Glove.
Yes?
Oh, Bluebeard's
Bride. Bluebeard's Bride. Yeah, we're definitely going to play Bluebeard's Bride as well.
And Pasión de los Pasiones.
Yes, that is the Powered by the Apocalypse game of the Spanish telenovela, where you play both the cast members and the family watching at home.
The show.
Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, yes. I've been watching that shit. That sounds amazing.
amazing.
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
If I could, so. I don't know. I'm trying to think if I could.
I'll send you the link. Please.
Oh my god.
Yeah. I don't know.
If you want to run it.
That totally sounds like being at my dad's mom's house as a kid, and there's nothing to do, and you're eating a bowl of ramen and watching Colin Poe.
Yeah. Watching Maria Lodabario.
Better, 'cause I don't know Spanish, and so growing up as a kid, I had no idea what was going on.
Yeah.
Which just made it even.
You're just watching people scheming in Spanish.
Yes.
Lots of crying.
So we'll
randomly
see
crying, exactly.
Meeting.
We'll be meeting again in the new year. So everyone have a great sacred time of your own.
Yes.
And,